I am in control. So, not in, in control of the stream, but I'm in control of your fate.
Oh no!
I thought we were playing 13th Age.
You'll, I'm
we
still in control
Smash
of that.
Bros.
Now, how'd you think that? What's wrong with
Look,
you?
Yeah, I thought we were all. Yeah, I thought we were all in control of our own fates. That's how this works, right?
Well, you can kind of nudge it in directions, and I'll probably say, "Yeah, that's cool," but I'm still the one in control.
Fine with me.
Right. Well, I've moved you with the powers of wizards.
Okay. Yeah.
I'll begin in just a moment. I'm getting heartburn.
Those nugs, man.
All those nugs they come back to you.
I shoved those nugs into my face about as fast as possible, all right?
You need to learn that at your speed eating.
I'm going to put on the tunes just in case.
We should tweet box this.
There we go. That's some tunes. I did tweet about this.
I retweeted it.
There we go.
Alright, I'm done having heartburn.
As did I. Alright.
Well, not really. I'm just going to thug through it now.
Let me tell you about a little something called tums.
I'm going to tell you something about it, something I don't have. It's called tums.
You and your no-tums household.
And just to give a quick discussion on this, every single one of these tokens is kind of like an old drawing I did a million years ago, and I'm just repurposing them for this purpose.
Sure.
They were all named by committee. So, not all of them were my own joke.
Gotcha.
Howdy, everybody. I'm running 13th Age for these nerds, because I am the biggest nerd of all.
King nerd.
I love this game. It's pretty good. A little bit of backstory here, because as far as I remember it, because it's been fucking months. Because think how this went down. Is that so now it would be only 14, alright, 14 people. Shit. I forget what this fucking plot point thing is. Alright, 5 more minutes, let me remember everything. We'll be right back.
I'm digging the names.
Alright, now I remember. Okay. So, in the town of Drakkenhall, which is a big hole fucking city of monsters, ruled over by 3 dragons who just kind of controlled the place, took over after this place seceded from the Empire. It's 13th Age, this giant empire ruled by an emperor, you know, as they are. Drakkenhall seceded from the Empire long-ass time ago. A couple dragons took over, a whole bunch of monsters moved in, now it's an entire city of monsters, and one of these monsters in particular is an old-ass minotaur named Yorgos Papadopoulos.
Man.
He's more better known as just George the Minotaur.
Oh. It's much easier
George
to remember.
George the Minotaur was a millionaire, more or less. He was really, really rich. He made most of his money in housing. He was known for his really bizarrely laid out labyrinthine housing, which just appeals to monsters in general. You know how they do.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, just about 2 weeks ago, Yorgos fucking died.
Oh no!
Uh-oh.
Of natural causes. He lived a long, rich life.
My rent controlled housing!
No one controls housing right now. It's kind of a shame, actually. And he was known as an eccentric. You know, as rich people often are. And he had no children or whatever and didn't really believe in leaving things to heirs anyway. So he kind of sold everything in his will. Not sold. Gave everything away in his will. And right now, what's being read off is his last will and testament. To 14 fuckers that just got picked up off of the road.
Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's usually how it goes in Drakkenhall.
Yes. He just the lawyer over here has spent like the past hour reading off a whole bunch of bullshit that's not necessarily relevant to any of you. But he leaves it off with, and to the 14 people who were essentially restrained and then dragged in here against their will, I leave to you my manor, if you can find it. Across the city, I've left a bunch of tablets that, if you can discover their secret, you will find the path to my hidden manor.
Hmm.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's nice, I suppose.
Yep. So, go. Go get the house. The fuck are you doing? Go get the house.
I have two questions.
Okay.
What's a house, and what's a manor?
Alright, so you see the thing that you're in right now?
Yes.
It's kind of like this, but bigger and nicer.
Explain.
Okay. So you know how this is full of stone flooring and all that, and some idiot just like drew wizards on the ground underneath all of these desks?
Yes, it's very sturdy. Very safe in here.
Well, it would actually be made of wood, so I don't know. Maybe your sensibilities don't really work out with wanting to get a house. Even so, that house is also full of riches. So if you want to get rich, go get the house.
What if I don't believe in houses? Like, what if I'm, like, moralistically opposed to the concept of houses? Can I still get the house?
I have a further question.
Mm-hmm.
Is it important to be rich in your world?
Yes. Pretty much everyone just kind of looks away after you hear that.
So... I'm out the door and down the street already.
Yeah, I can see that. And for your question, Frog, absolutely, you can still have the house if you're morally opposed to the idea of housing in general.
I see. Thank you.
You are actually given pretty much free reign of whatever the hell that you want to do with it after you find it and get it.
Interesting.
Got lost and ended up back here. I'm going to sit back down.
You're allowed to split up into teams, and I'd like you to kind of figure those out, because it can have up to 4 in team.
I'm liking that this frog's gumption. I'm teaming up with him.
Let me tell you, mister, let me tell you about a little thing called frogs.
I'm listening.
The fireball man in front of you kind of scoffs at the idea of wanting to team up with the frog.
Frog looks over there.
You hear him giggling. That fireball man is giggling at you.
Al pulls out a piece of paper out of his briefcase, and it has a list of names on it. Does he recognize any of the names of the people in here?
Currently, you don't know the names of the people in here, so that's a good question. They do all have actual names on top of their silly moniker.
All right, well, he heads over here and says, "So, what's your names?"
I am Bartholomew Flamebeard, Grand Wizard.
Do I see his name on my list?
Yeah, Wizard. And he's actually he's not wanted, but he's on a watch list. If you can, you're probably gonna want to avoid hanging out with Fireman here. With Bart.
Well, this is my case list. I kind of have to.
Yeah, Yeah, you do.
I was just hoping, you know, by chance that somebody would end up being in the right place, and it looks like that happened, so mm-hmm. I guess I'm going on this instead of getting back to work.
My name's Geros. I'm a frog. I want to tell you all, frogs are pretty great. Frogs aren't just a state of being. They're a way of life.
Oh, that's... okay. Sure. I'm Al. I work for the city.
He does. He does work for the city.
Garrus is nodding. He doesn't quite know why, but he's nodding approvingly. Not quite sure why.
What do you do?
Good to meet you, Al. For the city.
I go around and I make sure that people are happy and you know, and functioning.
What's make people happy and function?
Is frogs. It frogs?
Frogs help people function.
How do you help them function?
You know,
I find them work.
And, we should probably get going. The one of the groups.
Oh,
is,
you assign people things to do.
Basically, in some sense.
What should I do?
Well, for now, I guess this at least keeps us all busy. So how about we go try to find this manor or whatever?
That
I
sounds.
Got nothing else to do.
I will follow you.
The lawyer kind of steps into a strange red portal and just leaves. Now,
as
he's
they
just
do.
Leaving. He's already done his job.
As they do.
Yeah.
As
what
they do.
Lawyers do.
Yeah.
Lawyers are known for their propensity. Well, lawyers are known, for that.
That lawyer was obviously a demon, but, you know, it's...
That's what you do.
That's neither here nor there.
Yeah. I mean, that's just me profiling, really. I shouldn't have even brought it up.
I mean, it is a very common career path for demons.
Mm-hmm.
They love litigation.
They do.
So this manor.
Yeah, Yorgos Papadopoulos' manor is known for being something that you're going to have to make a check of some kind for. So, how about that, Bart? What kind of background do you think is relevant to knowing things about a manor?
Who, me?
Let's...
Bart, not Bort.
Okay. Oh, God. Oh, we do have a Bort.
It just occurred to me. This is going to be really confusing.
This is going to get confusing eventually.
Well,
I was just really confused because it's like, I don't know anything about manners. I'm still not sure why you would live in wood, but I've got this whole city thing down.
Well, as the son of a noble family, as part of my noble scoundrel background, I am familiar with layouts of manor districts and stuff. While this is
Well, you know things about house and big house, so go ahead, use that. Obviously with intelligence. I will also accept wisdom if you want to do worse, you know.
Let's go with intelligence.
All right.
So, where are the hotkeys, or do I just have to do this auto?
Okay, slash roll space, type in a 1d20 plus number.
D20 plus 4
Unfortunately, you would have to set up macros yourself, and I hate setting up macros, so good job.
I don't know shit about Drakkenhall's manners.
In fact, you might... How long have you been here, do you think? Considering you were originally in the Axis, I'm assuming, being from...
About a half hour.
Alright, that would explain that.
Yeah.
Yorgos is kind of a Drakkenhall-specific thing, and his house is very much so. Now, on the other hand, what about Al? What do you think Al knows about this kind of thing?
Well, he's been around the block, and I'm sure he's heard stuff about it, so he'll, since he's been, you know, used to going into bars and shady places, he's gonna use his background as a social worker to
bars and shitty places. Why do you think that would apply to be to knowing what one of the richest men in the city would know? I mean, I can think of other reasons why being a social worker would apply, so I'm gonna let you do it, but that wouldn't work.
Well, because, you know, word gets around. That's where rumors tend to spread.
All right, fair enough.
Anyway, so plus enter Wiz.
Ah. If you want to work out a thing here, yeah.
I don't know if there's another one to use that. Yeah, that's fine.
I misinterpreted you for a second there. Okay, I understand what you're talking about. Why in the world are these not looping? Oh, because I didn't set them to loop. That would explain that.
Hmm.
There you go.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
Hey, that's significantly better. I forget what the original question was.
Background. About
the manor. Knowing stuff about where the manor.
Alright, yeah, okay. So, about the manor. Yorgos fucking, you know, was, like I said, an eccentric. And he lived pretty much in seclusion. He came out pretty often, just like to explore the town. You could actually see him walking around with his, you know, hunched over in his, with his cane a lot. Just kind of going about the town, checking things out, because he didn't really have to do much of the real estate by himself at that point, because, you know, he was the CEO at that point. But he himself, where he lived, was completely secluded, and pretty much no one knew where it was. And that's part of why this is was essentially a rat race situation, where you have to go find the manor and claim the manor before anyone else.
Alright, so basically people see him walk around town, but they didn't know where he started.
Well, yeah, yeah.
Alright, then,
it's pretty common, honestly. Like, no one would be really paying attention too bad for that.
Hmm. Alright, then maybe we should start where we, recently saw him. Where people, like, saw him often.
Wait, I want to roll. I want to roll to attempt using my frog background to figure out what he has to do about frogs.
Okay.
All right. So, I'll use my wisdom, which is, you know. So, that would be dash roll plus
I forgot to mention, you also add your level to this, which is 2.
That's okay. Right.
Mm.
So, how do I roll this? Keep in mind that I'm not really that
sure.
Dash roll.
D20 plus 1d20 plus relevant modifiers. In your case, it would be your wisdom, your level, and your.
So, wisdom, overall wisdom plus level?
Your plus. Bonus, which is for you, is nothing.
Oh, yeah.
So, 0 plus 2 because of your level, and then plus 5 for being a frog.
So it'd be d20 plus 1d20 plus 0 plus 2 plus 5. I know a lot about frogs.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
I fucked up, sorry. You told me...
So minus the 6.
Minus the 6, sorry.
Yeah,
so,
all right.
What does he have to do
about frogs?
Though
I can respect that. He did like frogs.
Okay. I'm in.
He was not a member of being a frog.
Okay, that's a downside.
True.
All right. I'm forming opinions. I'm recollecting. I think we should find this guy's thing because frogs.
Fair enough.
I agree.
Frogs.
Get the fuck out of this building. Because it's
yeah.
Not doing much.
Let's leave this building. All right.
Yeah.
Let's get out of here. Yep.
These guys in the background are going to stay hanging out over here, though, because they like it. The wizard bot and the shy guy man gonna stay where they are in particular.
In my never ending quest to assimilate with the overworlders, I will follow the man who gives orders.
What is that right now? I think that might be the frog right now.
I was going with the silver servant. As he has stated, his job in the collective is to distribute the work.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
As is how things work.
That's a good point.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Is this intended to be a blank screen right now?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. We entered the void between worlds.
So I'm just going to have to bring in tokens every now and again.
Sure.
Immediately outside, you know, walking right outside of the door, building, the city hall, more or less, the morgue, wherever that would be read off. You are immediately accosted by two excited-looking folks. Yo, dog, what the hell was in there? I heard that something important went down.
Well, yes,
it's very important. I was given a job.
Man, I could have used that. I mostly just spend my day just hanging out on the street. You know, hoping someone pays attention to me.
Well, names?
That is Candy, with an I, and, Theodosa.
Okay, Candy and Theodosa, I will, get your names in the office, you'll have, agents in 4 to 6 weeks.
Hold up. I have a job.
Oh, okay, sorry.
I barely know this man.
Okay. I've Candy, then. 4 to 6 weeks, you'll have an agent who will help you find work.
Excellent. Now, how about my actual question? What went on in there?
It wasn't much, you know. There wasn't much going on there. It had very little things to do about frogs, you know. Frogs are really important. And, you know, how do you guys feel about frogs? Let me ask you something. How do you guys feel about frogs?
Usually your kind is translucent and cannot see.
True. At least the ones that live in caves. That's absolutely true. You can see their little insides.
If you want to know more about what was in there, there's still some people in there. Go ask them.
Yeah, but we're not actually allowed inside.
Why?
You know. Mm-hmm. That wasn't actually a public building. That was private. That was a private function you just attended.
Ah, okay.
I am making a check here to know what you went or here makes it is important.
Okay.
Well, there are some official business with the recently deceased.
Oh, dang. Who died? Oh, wait, wasn't that... what was his name? George? It wasn't George, was it?
Sorry.
No?
It was George, I'm sorry.
It's public knowledge that he died. It's not public knowledge that he was giving things away.
Yeah, no, it's... I'm sorry, George is dead.
Well, I like I said, I knew that. I was just... I didn't
it
know...
Was, it was pertaining his death.
Okay. Well, dang. So I'm assuming that's already all done.
Yep, all wrapped up.
I mean, I went to the expo earlier about his stuff. You know, big ass expo of like his miscellany magic items or non-magical but still impressive items, and also his paintings, his personal paintings.
Did he paint them himself?
Yes.
Oh.
You know, it's just down the street and, like, to the right. Have you been there yet? It's pretty nice.
I just got here.
Oh. That sucks.
I don't trust this guy. Can I roll sort of thing to see if I should not trust this guy?
Yes. You are absolutely allowed to do that.
Okay, what would I be rolling here to see what the fuck this guy's deal is? This guy seems really untrustworthy.
Wouldn't it be inspirational croaking for monsters, unfortunately?
No. Can I use my frog background?
How good are frogs at discerning the intentions of people, do you think?
Terrible.
So no, you can't use your frog background.
Okay, can I just roll a dice?
Yes, absolutely.
So what stats go into this?
Now, traditionally... Wisdom is the stat that goes into this.
So I just
roll
it.
However, if you want to chum up a little and see kind of like just.
Okay. Let's give this a shot. Okay, so I'm going to try using my charisma to try to get some kind of a idea of what this guy's deal is. Get him to kind of let me in on a little thing. Kind of kind of put the frog on them. You know what I'm saying?
A wink, wink, nudge, nudge sort of situation.
Yeah, kind of just move up to him, like, between you and me being a frog and you being, what is this guy? Do I even know what this guy is?
That's clearly the fighting freak Knuckles.
Well, what is he? Is he some type of a kidna?
Some kind of large thing with dreadlocks and six eyes. It like
sure.
What you see on the picture is what it is. I don't know what it actually like translates out to in game terms, but that's what it looks like.
Does he look vaguely amphibian?
If those are actually no, he wouldn't have gills. That's right, because amphibians would breathe through their skin.
Some do have gills, though.
All right, well, in that case, if those aren't eyes on the face and are, in fact, gills, then would be maybe a little bit amphibious.
So,
in this case, I'd probably take Inspirational Croaking.
Okay. Well, yeah, because Inspirational Croaking, because it allows me to try to get the charisma on. Okay, so I'm going to apply my Inspirational Croaking for Monsters background.
Yep.
Because, you know, you do.
And your charisma.
And my charisma. Life. Okay, so roll
1d20.
Yep.
Plus 5, plus 2.
Almost wrote 1d0. That's a completely different thing. Mm-hmm. All right. So I'm trying to get an understanding and try to chum up on him to get a gun. Yeah. So guys, what's the deal here, huh? Between you and me, you vaguely thing, you know, like frogs. Yeah, come on, huh?
He looks around real quick.
I heard that there was something going around with like a giveaway,
so I wanted to get in on that.
Well, it's not so much a giveaway, so much as like a challenge. It's kind of lame though. Involves houses, which I don't believe in. So you know, whatever. I'm just kind of doing this because, hey, you hear the good word about frogs?
You're just kind of twirling on the spot right in front of him when you're talking about this.
Absolutely. Great. You know, because, like, frogs, yeah. Can I try rolling frog against this guy to try to convert him to frog?
Okay.
Let's get this out the door right away, okay? Let's try converting this man to frog. So,
all right, go ahead.
Okay, I got my book of frog. All right, let's try converting this guy to frogs.
He's going to read a section of the book of frog to him.
Yes. Let me tell you about the good book. It's about a frog. You know, frogs, they have semi-permeable membranes. They lay eggs in water. You know, frogs, they can do a lot of things.
Yeah.
You know, frogs can do things with themselves. You should consider frogs. It's really good at it. All right, let's roll here. What would I be doing here to convince him? Like 1d20 plus same roll as previous, basically?
Yes, but replace one of the twos with another five because you're using the frog instead of...
Yeah, I'm using my frog background here, yeah.
You can absolutely kind of get out of it. I knew this was going to happen.
I think I just converted this man to frog.
Yeah. This kind of spontaneously shrinks down and goes on all legs and starts to hop away.
Frog takes people in different ways. Some people just become frogs. Some people just like frogs.
What the fuck?
Hello, Mr. Fishman. Have you ever heard the good word about frog?
No, he just pushes you away, like nudges you with his foot.
All right, no. To each their own. Do I notice that those other guys are gone now?
Yeah, we can do that.
All right. Oh.
You just got the fish, the mushroom man with you now.
Yep.
Tell me, Mr. Fungus, have you heard the good word about frog?
Well, what? I mean, we have them.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Where are you from? What's your deal? You from a swamp? I'm from a swamp.
What's a swamp?
It's like a big water. It's kind of like a bog.
Someone walks by.
Oh, okay. It's like a bog. That I understand. We have bogs.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Like I said, you generally, where I come from, frogs are translucent and can't see.
Yeah, I've heard about that. Those guys are pretty cool.
Yeah.
My aunt's one of those.
Someone walks by when you mention, yeah, it's like a swamp, right? And he yells out, "Yo, swamps suck!" Just gives you the dull birds walking backwards away from you.
Fuck you!
Eat a dick!
Go to hell! Frog hell! That's especially bad! There's no frogs there!
Well, I don't know what happened to the guy that gave me an order, but he told me to go find that house, so I'm just gonna go find that house.
We should go find that thing, I guess.
I guess.
So, knowledge you learned from that escapade is you actually gave information that, well, the giveaway thing happened. Although not enough to really give them any information about it, because you got to use that guy.
I did turn that one guy maybe into a frog.
Maybe temporarily, maybe permanently. We'll never know.
He's out eater.
I would go get food.
Okay. And the only other thing is that you learned about apparently an expo going on about all of the deceased's shit. No.
Uh huh. Okay. Hey guys, what are you up to?
Eating food.
Okay, cool. Already so, ate.
Guy mentioned. Uh-huh.
What?
Expo.
I'll tell you what. How about you? You go check out that expo. We'll ask around here, and we'll meet up in an hour.
Expo. Are you gonna split into two groups? That's totally loud. This is not a game where that is super dangerous or anything. I mean, not honestly. I'm not saying that.
We're not exactly in a dungeon.
Yeah.
Yeah. We should split up. Try to spread out to find more information.
Okay.
Yeah. I agree.
What are we looking for?
I think we're looking for a house or like tablets about a house. Yeah.
The thing that you heard was that apparently there's a bunch of tablets just like lying around the city or whatever, and those hold the secret to finding the mansion. Banner. Villa.
I'm going to take a casual glance for one of these tablets at the diner I'm at.
You're good. You're looking out. I can appreciate that. There is definitely a tablet at the diner, but it appears to be a menu.
Okay, well, I call over the waitress working in the bar.
Oh, hold up. I have a token. I have just a giant repository of tokens I'm going to be using here, so...
Do it.
Good.
All right, so...
Do you have any idea what the tablets are supposed to look like? Mm-hmm. Also, what's a tablet?
Okay.
It's a rock.
How do you know about a rock?
Tablet's like a thing with words, kind of like this book. Shows a book about frogs, but made out of stone.
So I want to ask her if she's seen anything around town. Looks suspicious. Somewhat tablet-like. It's not normally there.
Oh, what'd you say, Tears?
That I'm not sure that I'm illiterate.
That's a good, you know, that's fair. I'm not going to make any assumptions about that. It's up to you.
Well, considering why people basically talk through the fucking vines and don't really have a thing, I don't think I'm literate. So that'll go well.
Yep, yep.
I'm glad he went to the diner and not me, or I would be coming back with a menu.
That's fair.
To be honest, I'm not sure my character's literate either. Even though
Well, it's great that they put us together, then, isn't it?
Yeah. To be fair, he does have a book about a frogs, but I'm not sure there's anything in there but, like, diagrams of frogs.
Does he know if it's actually about a frog?
I think if we ever get to a point where that comes up, we may have to roll some sort of checks about that.
Actually about a frog?
Yeah. I don't know.
All right, so Al and Bart, the two smart ones, and then Bort and Geros, who are a couple of dumb idiot fuckers.
I'm just out of my element. Once we're not in, you know, a city, it'll be fine.
Well, this is the great campaign.
I've got Dicktron on lockdown. It's just this whole, like, being a civilized, functioning member of civilization thing that's sort of an issue.
Yeah, you know what? Checking it out, you are the second smartest person. So
that's really sad.
Yep.
Because my intelligence is not that great. It's just above average.
All right, so something odd going on in the city?
Yeah, like I hear there's tablets floating around places. Have you heard about anything like that? Seen anything?
No tablets, but I have heard a lot about orbs lately.
Orbs, huh?
Orbs?
Mm-hmm. Orbs.
I know a bit about orbs. What's the word about the orbs?
Well, you know, just kind of the general seeing orbs floating around at night kind of thinger.
Okay, as orbs do.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, that's right, we're not in Horizon. They don't do that here.
It happens occasionally, but not often. It usually means something going on with wizards.
Wizards.
I wonder if I could track these wizards using magic.
You're not allowed. You're not allowed to do that. You're going to be breaking the law.
Yeah.
Listen, you can't do that. We have privacy laws in state here. Wizards cannot use magical means to track other wizards.
I just remembered something that I forgot to do because I don't usually do it. I'm going to do these for you because there's a number to do it. There's buttons to do it, I suppose.
Okay.
Keep going. I can multitask here.
Look, what I'm saying is we're not technically in the Empire right now. So these laws pertaining to me.
That's it's a Drakkenhall specific law, actually.
Oh, well, never mind then.
I mean, I'm not the police or anything. I have no power to stop you, but I mean, I'm just letting you know.
I probably wouldn't be able to do it anyways. You ever pissed off a wizard?
Once, a long time ago.
Yeah, it's not fun.
Al looks off wistfully. So nothing about tablets, though? It's only about these orbs? Alright, well, thank you.
Well, have a good day, honey.
So where will this gallery be?
The gallery is just kind of... It's not that hard to... It's not that easy to miss, really. It's hard to miss, is what I'm getting at. You just walk down the street, and then you'll find, like, a kind of makeshift series of curtains.
Okay.
And people just kind of, like, standing out in front.
Okay. Bort, we should go look at this gallery thing. Maybe there's a tablet there. It's kind of like art, I guess. You know what art is?
Yes. We have a fine tradition of art. Though the surface worlders is not as good. Very little glowing. Also very small.
See, I can understand that as well. I can sympathize. I do not get this terrestrial art. It's weird. It's not enough frogs. I don't know.
I did this in the background. And I took into account Geros' thinger, too. Geros, you have a 6 and a 5. Both with... sorry. You have a 6 and a 5, one with the priestess and one with the 3. I have this results of icon dice.
Okay.
I'm going to keep a note of these.
Okay. 6 and a 5.
And I will pretty much offer uses for these as the game goes along.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Bort has a 6 with the High Druid and one with the Elf Queen. A 5 with the Elf Queen.
6 and a 5. Got it.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, Bart has nothing.
Aww.
Because it's not Bort.
And Al has the a 6 with the Great Gold Worm.
Hmm.
Right, you can offer ideas for these. I can offer ideas for these. They're kind of a general purpose. Okay, things aren't going right, so maybe I can work this in my favor sort of dice thing, right? And okay. If you use the fives, things can also go wacky. Sixes are always unambiguously good for you. Fives are usually good, can go wacky. That's the idea. All right, back to this. The expo is kind of just down the street. There's a whole bunch of makeshift curtains as walls. Okay. There's guards just kind of standing out in front of it because there's a whole bunch of valuable shit in there. They don't want you stealing any of it.
All right, as I do.
Frogs and it's full of people just walking in and out of it because they're checking out all of the cool stuff they will never get because they're all poor.
Okay. Can I get some sort of... Do I see any obvious tablets inside this collection?
No obvious tablets.
Any unobvious tablets?
Possibly. You'll have to check.
What should I roll here to see if we see any tablets?
What would that take? Because I am also looking for potential rocks that have weird squiggles on them.
Perception usually is also traditionally wisdom. Not necessarily has to be, if you don't want it to be. And you can bring up a relevant background as well.
Well, I could try converting one of these guards to frog again to see if that helps. But that might be counterproductive.
That also doesn't necessarily help you find tablets.
Well, yeah, the guards may not know.
I'm a master of Earth.
It is true, you are a master of Earth.
Tablets
you can probably identify tablet just at a glance, even if you can't read it.
Yeah, probably.
I'll accept that.
Okay. So how do I roll on this thing? I wasn't paying attention.
You have to pull up the chat.
Slash roll. On the chat. Slash roll, space, 1d20, plus relevant modifiers.
Yep, and it'll be my wisdom.
Wisdom, also your level, and a relevant background.
I don't know if my back. Let's see. Hang on.
It's a tunnel scout, I suppose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's. We probably.
Generically perceptive.
I assume that my people have some form of glyph communication that they use. It's just not. I wouldn't call it literacy in the traditional state.
Yeah, it's kind of more like call signs.
Glyphoracy.
Yeah.
Essentially, you know hobo call signs?
Yeah, that's what I was basically going with, yeah.
That is literally your language right there, the hobo call signs. Oh, dang. That's no immediately obvious tablet.
That is an awful fucking roll is what that is.
Yeah, no immediately obvious tablets in your vicinity.
Okay.
Yep, because I rolled a 4. Just for
out
those
of four,
you playing.
You're looking for the obvious ones.
Yep.
All right.
I got a 12 off of a 4 at least.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
All right, so I'm going to also try looking around. I'm not going to apply any background because...
How good are frogs at... How good is the eyesight of a frog?
Depends on the frog.
What kind of frog are you?
The best frog. I'm going to guess that he's got pretty okay eyesight, like human level. He can do frog-esque stuff with his eyesight, you know, relating to water, maybe dark. But beyond that, I don't think it would actually help in terms of, like, super perception of perception.
All right.
So I'm just going to...
Al and Bart are also showing up.
I'm walking in with meat on a stick in hand.
That's common. Don't worry about it. No one's going to feel bad. Like, no one's going to think that's trashy or anything.
You need to slather that all over the paintings. That's the only way we'll find out what's in under the paintings.
Hey, I'm eating this.
Can I have that stick when you're done?
Sure.
Sweet.
All right, I'm just going to roll a D. It would just be, for me, it'd just be a straight D20 then without any modifiers, right?
If you're not applying any bonuses whatsoever. No, it would be plus 2 because you still add your level.
Oh, yes, right. So 1 yep. D20 plus 2.
And
unless
stat.
You don't want. All right.
Poor frog.
There is no immediately obvious.
I'm going to claim it's because you're very close to everything.
But you do actually notice something.
Okay.
There's like this iron flask just kind of like hanging out in the back somewhere. That has like a little bit of a, you know, like the cold mist going on, condensation showing up from something being really cold.
Mm-hmm. The ominous mist, yeah.
Yeah, all right. So there's like there's a flask back there. It kind of shakes.
Okay. All right.
Just notice that. You don't, there's nothing.
Does it look like it's an exhibit, or is it just kind of there? Like, if I...
It is definitely an exhibit. It is a part of the, of this.
Okay. I'm going to walk up to that and kind of go like, huh.
Hop up to it.
Yeah. Hop up to it as you do and kind of just can kind of look at it like, huh. So I have no fucking clue what this is.
I'm going to check to see if there's like a placard or like, like a name tag saying what it is.
Do you yell that over to us?
Yeah, hey guys, look at this thing. Fucking weird, huh? Ain't a frog. It's like, I don't know. I just don't know. There's so many things in this world I don't know.
Right underneath there is a plaque describing what it is, and it's pretty much just Yorgos's personal water flask. That's all it says on it.
I don't know. This is a spooky mist. Don't really look like water. I know water.
It totally is water. It's just water vapor kind of coming off of it from being cold.
It ain't normal water.
It does look spooky, but...
Does it look magic? Because I know magic.
It's a, like, ice-cold flask in the middle of, like, a summer day. So, yes.
I'm going to roll for magic knowledge.
Knowledge is okay.
So I'm going to... Let's see. Will this be intelligence?
Yes.
Alright, so I'm gonna roll my...
Magically inept wizard.
Yes, magically inept wizard.
Yeah, okay. I was just thinking about that.
That's definitely
magic. No, that's definitely magic, but I don't know shit about it from there.
Alright. How many guards are there around us right now?
None that are looking directly at you. There's a...
Yep, it's magic. Like,
certainly magic.
I do know magic. It's totally magic water.
Okay, this is a little bit easier for you because you are a druid, and that's actually more relevant here.
Oh, okay, cool. Well, I also forgot to add my level, so I had 2+2 to that. I got a 16.
Oh, yeah, okay. There you go. That's
all right.
Basically beats it. There's probably some kind of spirit attached to this thing.
Oh.
Some kind of just thing that's hanging out inside there. Inside that bottle. Flask.
Ha.
So
that's where that cold is coming from. It's not just enchanted with something cold or whatever.
Oh, there's an air spirit in it.
Pretty much.
Sweet. I can't talk to spirits.
Oh, so are you actually letting us everybody know about this then?
Yeah, I just said that. There's an air spirit in there, and I can't talk to spirits.
He can talk to pretty much everything else.
Pretty much,
can't
yeah.
Talk to spirits.
Nope, didn't go that way. I decided I wanted to blow stuff up.
Do any ghosts live in Drakkenhall?
Totally.
All right. Yeah, you said there's a spirit in there.
Yep. Probably air. It's making it cold.
All right. I'm gonna roll, social worker plus charisma.
Okay.
I've had to master a few techniques to communicate with spirits in order to, get their information.
Alright, yeah, that works out.
Also, I want to point out that, out of character, that thing is kind of in bondage right now.
Yep, pretty much.
Maybe not. You don't know.
It could be into that, I guess.
Could just be where it lives.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, so
did you add your
level spirit?
That?
Yeah, I did.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hi, spirit. Yeah, we beseech you to speak with us.
The flask does not react, because then you just realize. Wait, I have to let it out of the flask to talk to it first.
All right, I'm gonna steal it. Fuck it. All right, what do I have to roll here to steal this successfully, or is it so trivial that I could just not really pocket it? Because I don't have pockets, but, like, could I grab it and stick it under,
okay,
like, Bort's
so
cap or something?
You, as a frog, can definitely not do sleight of hand. That's impossible, right?
That's true.
But you know what you can do? You can definitely do sleight of tongue.
I could stick it in my mouth.
Yes.
I mean,
I'm getting that.
All right, okay. Can I use my tongue on this thing? Can I apply my frog background to just... Fucking
yes,
tongue the hell out of this
thing.
I
would you to tongue the hell out of this thing.
Hell yeah! All right.
Can I make a distraction while he does this?
Yes.
That might call more attention, but I'll go for it.
I've got an idea.
Okay.
Take off all your clothes and just run through it.
All right, you do, have him do his thing first, and I'll do my role.
Yeah. That.
Okay, what's your plan?
All right. What would I roll to set something on fire?
It didn't take long to get here.
Using matches, not magic.
Okay. If you want to do it without someone noticing you, that's dexterity.
All right.
And your pyromaniac background, obviously.
Mm-hmm. I am going to try and set one of the curtains on fire. Nothing
bless you.
Expensive.
Thank you.
You're going to roll another 4. Oh, shit. Okay, fine.
25.
I was really hoping you were just going to roll another 4.
Look, I'm really good at setting stuff on fire.
All right. Now, while he's setting shit on fire, I'm going to roll something to see if I can get that. So I'm going to use my frog, my level, and the +3 for my dexterity, I presume, is probably the best thing here.
That would be dexterity as well, yeah.
Okay, I definitely... Yeah.
Frog is pretty good at his job.
Frog is good at frog.
So once the guard's actually like, no, what the fuck? No. Throw your body on it.
And then
he says to probably like a water thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, while that's going on, you just lash your tongue out, put that thing right into your mouth. It's really cold and uncomfortable.
Fuck. Good. I run outside.
We should follow that frog.
I mean, frogs can. A lot of frogs can freeze without issue, but it's still uncomfortable.
Okay, I run like across the street and I spit it out.
Yep. All right. No problem.
Blah.
What's actually on fire?
Just kind of the curtain walls. They'll get close. They'll get to it fast enough that nothing's gonna get damaged.
Sweet. Okay. Then I'm just gonna wander away.
Well, those are some nice curtains, though.
They are some pretty nice. No, they're not. They're actually really shitty.
Oh.
Oh, by the way, Bort, I'm done with the stick. Here you go.
Sweet. I'm gonna eat the stick.
Pretty good stick.
Yeah.
Alright. I don't know what the fuck this is.
Currently
what is this?
On the ground. It's
really alright, let me see it. I take the cap off the flask.
Same.
Hello, spirit. We beseech you to speak with us, and etc.
Oh man, that spirit's rad!
Too spooky for me.
It is, in fact, an air spirit. Just kind of like, it genies out of it, and it just kind of like freezes the air around it. You got a little, it's actually going to start to snow localized around it. And it's just going to give you a big old piercing red stare.
This always happens.
And what it's going to do is it's going to start signing at you. Like, with sign language.
Oh, okay. Well, I probably know that.
I don't know what he's doing.
That's your role to do it.
Okay, sure. D20.
Pretty much the same thing. I'll let you do intelligence instead of wisdom if you want, but you don't.
Yeah, I'll do wisdom.
I mean, I'll just let you do things that are bad for you if you want to. That's cool with me.
Yeah, totally. Hey.
You're really good at that. Okay, you know Drakkenhall sign language easy.
It's part of the job.
It's going to start signing at you. Hey, thanks. I've been in there for like, what year is it?
I tell them the year.
Yeah.
What year is it? That's a good question.
20XC6.
I can confirm it is the 13th age, though.
Yes. Right, well, I've been there for 30 years.
Oh. Okay.
It was a pretty sweet thing, honestly. It's alright.
Huh.
I bet I have so much cash coming in. Like, he's going to The spirit kind of turns around, looks at the sky real quick, and I never asked where I'm supposed to pick that up. Fuck.
Wait, does he know that his guy is dead?
Assumedly, just because he was let out. He wouldn't have been otherwise.
Sure. Oh, I see. So yeah, okay. He was on hire there. Okay.
Yeah. We might want to mention that.
So your boss had some. So we let you out. Actually, you wouldn't really understand me. Hey, Al, ask him about the tablets. Also, any cool facts he knows about frogs.
Al signs out what he knows about the tablets, and then reluctantly says, "Also, frogs."
First, the answer's about the frogs.
Hell yeah!
Frogs are pretty cool. I like how they can usually survive being frozen. That's a cool trick. Makes them, you know, animals that I can actually deal with.
Okay, I don't have a thumb, but I give him the thumbs up anyways.
Yep, I understand. And as far as tablets go, you know, actually, I do have a tablet in here. And it just kind of like reaches into the flask and somehow just kind of like pulls out, no problem. Kind of like, it does look like it elastically expands from being really tiny. The genie in the flask.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no, that's pretty standard operating procedure.
Same principle as a bag of holding. And, just not a bag.
I was using it to just kind of count down, because it's been a really long time.
And don't blame
he gives you he gives it to you, and then it's like coded in tic-tac-toe and like carved out solitaire somehow.
All right, okay.
Not that good at solitaire, are you?
Jake's head, no. I prefer spider solitaire.
I agree.
Much less vulnerable positions.
Alright,
anyway. I don't know what it was originally for. You just gave it to me and put it in, gave it to me and just sent me to the flask.
Well, thank you so much for your help!
Yeah. Alright. See you a little bit.
I should also mention that I signed to him that he might need to help him put out a fire.
Nah, he's immediately gone.
Alright, I say as he disappears, by the way, if you need any help working here.
Nope.
I'm sure he can find City Hall.
One of the sides of the tablet has like a section of an image on it, apparently.
Okay.
Possibly a section of map, as you would expect.
Will I need to decipher it, or is it pretty easy to tell?
It's pretty plain text.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe George didn't have like a high expectation of the people that he was going to give his manor to.
Don't blame him.
Can I get ye flask?
No, unfortunately, you cannot get ye flask.
Oh, the flask obvious is broken.
Obvious exits are north, south, and Dennis.
Okay, but what about the actual flask now? Is this flask cooled or warmed to a point where I can actually hold the flask?
It's not cooled down just yet, but it's cooling down.
Is there okay, real quick. Is there anybody nearby who looks really gullible?
Oh, absolutely.
Hey, Bort standing right here.
Guys, shut up. I learned some tricks to make it here. Wandering is a frog fit. I had to walk, get around to get over here, and it was rough. You had to make money your way any way as you could. Check this out. Hello, mister. Hey, hello. Ooh. Would you be interested in an awfully cool flask? Check this out. Does he like the flask?
Guys, I think
he's trying to get a good look in.
Okay.
I'm just trying to get a good look on the flask. He happens to be distressingly large.
Okay.
Very big. And I worry that the frog has picked the wrong person to talk to.
Does he like ye flask?
He kind of like picks it up in his grip and
It's a pretty high quality It's a pretty high quality flask. Rumor is that this actually may have once been in a high profile art gallery, in fact. It may have even belonged to... What was his name again?
George. Georgos Papadopoulos, also known as George the Minotaur.
George the Minotaur, yes. George the Minotaur's own cooled flask. Feel how cool it is. It's awfully cool, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Hell yeah.
Now, good sir, how about you... How would you like to own this flask?
It nods. Yes, I would like to own this flask.
Okay, what would be a going... Okay, I'm going to go back here. Hey, Al, what's a going price for a flask here? I don't even know what those are, really.
About 2 gold pieces.
I wish I had another stick.
You can find another stick if you want. It's like all around the place.
I will sell you this for 4 gold pieces and good stick.
He holds up 3 and he pulls out an excellent stick.
All right, we got a deal here, mister.
All right, so Al wasn't really paying attention, and then he looks over to see who he's talking to, and he comes up and he says, "Now, Mr. Discretionally Large, what do we say about impulse purchases?"
Oh, wait.
Shut up.
He just buy the flask, so there's no taking it back now, but yes.
I'm already eating that stick.
no backsies. All right, thank you, good sir. And if you ever find yourself in a swamp, look up frogs.
It's okay. We'll talk about this later.
I give him a pat on the leg and just walk away.
Swamps are fucking good.
I fucking hate you. I am going to fucking murder you, you spider lady. God.
Calm down, girls. Calm down. We can do this later.
I'm going to fucking kill that lady.
It's spiders in my eyes, Johnson.
I fucking hate him.
So as you leave the expo, Mr. Distressingly Large actually gets tackled by a whole bunch of the guards.
Hell yeah!
We'll talk about that later.
Because they noticed that he totally had that flask, and he was apparently like, no, did he set that on fire? I like that guy, though. He's a pretty good, nice guy. Nope! Tackle him. Like, they tackle him, but they're all much smaller than he is. They just kind of end up hanging off of his, like, horns and his arms.
We should probably regroup back at base, a.k.a. the diner.
Alright, so...
I'm okay with this.
Alright, let's
take a look at that tablet.
Yep.
Just to look at it. So that I know what I'm supposed to be looking for.
Hold up. Like, what
gas is rising in my chest. Give me a second.
Yeah. Like, what information did we actually get from this tablet? I may have missed that. Out of character here for a moment.
It's part of a map.
From maps you've seen, this is basically a third of a map.
A third of a map. Okay. So we don't really have any hints about where the other tablet would be at this moment, right?
Ah, well, while analyzing the map, you get a little bit of an inkling that because it doesn't have an X on it, but it does have kind of like markings on it in places that aren't tic-tac-toe.
Interesting. So it has other markings on it that seem to indicate locations.
Yes. Interesting. Such as outside the city.
Ooh.
Perhaps we should leave the city, because, correct me if I'm wrong, you said that he made the map sort of a pathway, like, to the manor?
Supposedly, we need more pieces of this, because this is an incomplete map, though.
Yes.
Yeah, well, what I'm getting at is...
It might be that the other points marked on...
The next piece.
Because the other points marked on it might be... Have other tablets, maybe. I don't know. Theoretically. Or at least more information.
Let me take a look at that map. Al grabs it and looks it over. Hey, it says there's something in City Hall. Wait. No, that's a doodle of an air elemental. That's not it.
Actually a really good doodle.
That guy's a good artist.
I really like that guy. I like his opinions on frogs.
Speaking of artists, I mentioned that George actually had his own art on display in there, and it basically looks like, 10-year-old did them.
Is it basically George W's?
Pretty much.
Great. Well,
I guess the only real. So, what does this X look like? Like, where is this X?
It's kind of like slightly outside the city, next to a farm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's check out this X. I'm not sure what that is, but okay.
It's near a farm. Let's go to the farm.
I don't feel how I feel about farms. All right, let's go.
Bort, you know about plants, right?
Yep. What do you need to know?
Okay. What kind of plants do they make on farms? I don't know what a farm is, people. I've lived in the city for a really long time.
It depends on the farm. Generally... You know, like, it depends on what crops they're harvesting.
Well, there's corn farms, there's wheat farms, there's mushroom farms.
Corn, I know what that is. Let's go to the corn farm.
I know what corn is. Let's do corn. Hell yeah, corn. I fucking love corn.
My people traditionally do mushrooms and glow bulbs.
Yeah, Bart is very much a city folk kind of person.
I don't really believe in agriculture. Except for swamps.
Al starts to say, "What do you believe?" And then he catches himself halfway through.
Geros gets really excited for a second, then stops.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, all right. So, let's head towards this farm.
Swamps are for bitches.
All right. I'm going to roll perception on that guy. Where is he nearby?
He is not.
Damn it.
That was actually sounded like it came from really far away or away. Like, holy shit, that guy's got some excellent hearing. At the farm.
All right.
What to do just hanging out here at the farm. Actually, they're getting off of a hayride that actually goes between the farm and the city.
Oh, man.
That farm, that trip was really great.
Man, that guy really needs to chill out.
Hey, man, everybody loves hay rides. Even me, who doesn't believe in farms.
Oh!
Hey, y'all, you know anything about tablets?
No!
Is there livestock?
Livestock, yeah. There's livestock. There's pigs. They're just hanging out. Farm is actually kind of muddy, you know. Kind of farm grows really gross stuff, honestly. All right, so you're at home here.
Yep. It's comfortable here. I'm in my element.
So do any of these, so these all look like they're people just visiting? They don't look like they're actually like farm folk? The farm folk?
Lovecraft monster here is wearing a set of overalls, so...
Okay.
I wish we knew how long ago that flask was infiltrated into that art show.
That's a good question.
That is a good question. Huh.
I am tempted to kind of conversate with this fellow to see if he knows anything about what was his name again?
George.
George, yes.
The Minotaur.
We should try talking to this fellow. He might know something about George. He looks like a farm guy that this is the place on the tablet. Why not? What could possibly go wrong?
Yeah, actually, I buried him here. We buried him here.
Oh, this is where George died?
Yeah, No. This is where he wanted to be buried.
Oh, this is where George's corpse lives. Oh,
yes, in the ground.
Oh well, okay. That's kind of Where is he buried at? Where would his gravestone be?
Well, if you just turn around and go over that hill, you can actually find the dais where we have a monument to the man.
I see.
Mm-hmm. And if you and were to, that... and if for some reason you were to dig him up, you would actually find that he was immaculate.
Oh, I see. I see. Oh. I don't suppose you happen to have any shovels around here.
We're not digging up.
Of course.
We're not.
Get out of here.
Calm down, Frog.
He goes ahead and like, well, why don't you just look here? He pulls out from his like from behind him. There could not possibly be there. There immediately hands you with four shovels of differing sizes, so even Gira could hold and use one.
Well, thank you, kind sir. We're gonna go go off and dig holes.
I sure hope you're not digging him up.
No, who would do that?
That would be ridiculous.
That would be silly. Hey, Bort.
That would be rude.
Hey, Bort, you want to go dig up a corpse?
Yeah, okay.
Sounds God, good.
Frog gets shit done. All right, wait, what's this guy? That guy is... I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that guy. What's with that guy? Can I perceive that guy? What's with that guy? Yes. I'm gonna roll
right now.
I'm gonna roll a perception on that guy. I don't trust that guy.
Is that guy just running away or something?
No, he's very obviously tailing you.
All right. Oh. Do I notice that guy, or do I have to roll to see if I notice that guy?
It's super obvious.
All right, super obvious. I notice that guy. I'm just gonna roll a d20 plus nothing +2 because that's all I got really for perception here.
Okay.
I'm not very perceptive. I don't notice shit.
All you notice is this guy is following you. Obviously, that's it.
Hey, Bort, there's like some kind of bird thing following us. I don't like birds.
The fuck is a bird?
Oh, he kind of looks like a bird. I don't know. Geros has a very limited perspective here. All right, so we find this monument, I take it then, yes?
Yes, very obviously.
Okay. What does this monument look like?
Why? It looks like... just like a fucking monument. Like, the dais. That's it.
Is there anything
on... It is inscribed with just a message of farewell to our beloved George the Minotaur. He sold houses, and it was great.
It's some kind of code.
Alright, well, I asked Bort. So, you have, Earth powers, right?
Yeah, let's go with that.
So, could you, tell us anything about the body without, say, digging it up?
Like with these shovels I found.
Without digging it up.
Hey, with these shovels.
Can I see that shovel you got?
You can have one of the shovels, because you're going to help me fucking dig this hole. I give him a shovel.
Let me just look at a glass thing. Really quick. Talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to go discard this.
There is a tree growing near the dais.
Aha! I'm going to go talk to that tree.
Okay, good.
Hell yeah.
I'm going to go discard of this shovel because we're not digging up his corpse.
You're the worst pyromancer ever. Maybe you're not.
You can certainly talk to the tree.
All right, I'm gonna go talk to the tree.
Well, he's talking to the tree. So, Al, what's the charge? The going charge for grave robbery these days? My frog people kind of have a very different perception on these sort of things. I don't really truck with these kind of city perceptions of things. Frogs do their own thing.
An exceptional amount of money and a couple like months of jail time.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay.
They would figure out how to jail a frog, by the way.
They
it's
would
not
know.
That hard to jail a frog. It's
The thing is about frogs is that frogs can go into like a hibernative state, so it wouldn't even matter. It's like, I'll see you guys in a couple years.
Yeah, they'd probably be okay with that, frankly.
They would like nothing even happened.
The tree stands there ominously.
Hail.
What's up, dog? I'm a tree. I breathe or out breathe.
Yep, this is usually how this goes.
I'm made out of bark.
Shut up about yourself for a second.
I okay.
I have a question for you.
Oh yeah, dog, shoot.
When they put the flesh being in the ground underneath the circular stone.
Yeah.
Was he holding? Did they put things in there with him?
Oh yeah.
Rocks and the like.
Rocks got like slab metal disc thingies.
All right, that is actually was one of them. I'm just gonna make a vague, like, give me that tablet. Did one of them look like this?
I'm a tree. I can't see.
Shit, that's right. Feel this. Does one of them feel like that?
You just gotta like rub it up onto the
yes.
tree.
Yes.
Oh yeah, one is like that. I can touch it with my root.
All right.
I live where my roots are.
Yes. So do I, actually, but we'll get into that later. All right.
Keep in mind, we can't actually hear him.
Nope. Keep in mind, I'm not actually talking at this point.
Yeah.
I've just slapped my... I've just got tendrils out at him. It's got...
So you yelled, give me this.
All right.
Now,
don't that just
get weird.
So, did Bort tell any of us about this stuff, or what?
I don't know why he wouldn't.
I haven't quite yet, because I'm trying to figure out if I can do a thing.
Okay. Do what you gotta do, man.
Which I don't think I'm high enough level for my summoning spells, am I? That makes me sad. I think I have to be a little bit bigger before I can do that. That would have made things way easier. Nope, third level. Crap.
Well.
All right. I will. Thank you for the conversation, tree.
Yeah, no problem, dog. I'm always here. I'm a tree.
Yep.
I guess you could call him.
I can't move.
The giving tree?
How close are your roots to that?
Pretty close. I can touch it.
I'm going to give the tree earth strength. Hey, you want to pull that thing out of the ground?
Hell yeah, dog! This fucking explodes.
I'm just, imagining the dubstep just all of a sudden starts playing.
I can do that.
How does the guy in the distance seem to be taking the fact that this tree is all of a sudden hulking out?
I'm going to play the first thing that comes up with dubstep. All right?
All right.
If it sucks, well, that's okay.
Because that's dubstep.
That's to be expected.
So I turn around from looking at the guy following us. What's going on?
Oh, this tree's freaking the fuck out. I don't know.
Oh. Okay.
Hopefully, also is just lifting the corpse or the coffin up to the earth as well. But you know,
yeah, pretty much. It kind of like blew up the dais. Like, this is extremely loud. You hear pretty much the ground explode. It rips up the dais. It pulls the coffin right out.
Oh, hold on,
this is terrible.
Oh,
I've just got my hand on the tree, so it's subtle as a brick.
I'm gonna go back to my old man nap.
What did you do, Bort? What happened?
One of the tablets is in the coffin.
Oh. Hmm.
So I've retrieved the coffin.
That presents a moral quandary.
Nah, it's cool, man. That thing's dead. Trust me. I'm a priest.
Dead, but he also put his own tablet within the coffin, so he wants us to dig it up?
Hell yeah.
Hello, hi, sir.
Hey, the bird guy showed up.
Wait, did you say we fucked up or this is fucked up?
That was fucked up.
I know, right? Is he into it? Can I get a perception whether he's into it or he's not into it?
Yeah, you can do that.
Okay, I'm gonna roll perception to see if he's into it or not. I have no clue if he's into it or not, do I?
It's really ambivalent. Like, he sounds like he might be into it a little bit. He might be a little bit aroused, but he also might be really disgusted.
Okay, can I? All right.
Look, this is private business. If you wouldn't mind giving us some space.
I've heard stories of this kind of thing. They're all fucked up.
Trust me, I know.
I think you're messing with stuff. You shut it.
Probably.
It's okay. I'm on a mission from God, kind of.
Okay then. Bye.
I'm on a mission from Frog. I'm about frogs, you know. I don't know if I mentioned it. Frogs, pretty good.
Once or twice, I think.
Okay. Well, as long as we're just to be clear, frogs. All right. Let's
look in the coffin because they're just standing around not doing.
All right. I'm gonna go help out.
It's being suspended right now. By the tree, and it's probably going, like, you're gonna have to take it down later because it's worn off now, and it's just kind of like hanging from this tree.
Yeah, I'll pull it down.
I was really hoping you were just gonna open it so that the body would fall out in front of you.
Hell yeah, yeah. do that thing. I don't care if it's set up at this point. Splatter them bones.
I understand death and the things around that because they got very mad when I called them lunch boxes.
All right, so in there you find the half-rotted body of a minotaur.
Oh.
And holding, clutching, actually a painting. And there's a whole bunch of rocks and coins in there.
Just like
not a painting,
petals?
Just a canvas. Sorry.
Is there any? I'm just gonna hand the canvas to Al. Does this
Thank
say anything?
You?
It is completely blank. It is also really lumpy, bizarrely enough.
That seems like a thing we need to perceive.
I'm gonna start digging a new hole and like beside the tree.
I mean, you're not gonna be able to really hide that this was just grave robbed because the monument exploded.
Well, yeah, I'm not. You'll find out what I'm doing when I'm done with the hole.
Fair enough.
I have to pay back the tree.
Oh no.
You can just extrapolate from there.
Alright. Okay, so it's immediately obvious that the canvas is lumpy?
Yes.
Alright.
Like you grab it, you like run your hand across it, and it's like bumping all up and down.
Oh, while I'm digging, I'm gonna have my little buddy pull all the coins out of there because I don't want the metal to hurt the tree.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by the way, I just sort of spawn a smaller mushroom off of my back.
Hell yep. Yeah.
That's cute and also Funny. Gross.
I'm for it.
So
I'm still
asleep.
I'm kind of into spawning.
I rip at the
Yay!
I rip at the canvas a little bit.
The fuck?
What?
My computer just went into, like, switch user mode for some reason.
Huh.
Can you choose not to switch users?
The hell?
Can you get canceled?
The letter L apparently does it.
Surprise!
So L is... Are you holding control down right now? Because control L is lock, which is also switch users.
I'm not holding control down right now, no.
Surprise!
Sounds like you need less control in your life.
It's like it's pushing it down on its own.
All right. You are you able to hit cancel on it? With your mouse?
Yes, but I can't press the letter L now.
Okay. Is L still do that?
Oh, I need just the mushroom talk to the tree picture.
Oh God, why is everything dying?
Because that's exactly how that worked.
No, my keyboard just keeps fucking up. All right, I turned my keyboard off. Maybe that'll help.
Yeah, I think every time you need to get that thing working.
I love the mushroom talking to the tree, because that's pretty much exactly how that worked. Yo, dog, feel this. Throw one of those in there. Here, I'm going to give you the strength of a mountain. Can you get me that course?
Okay, this is fucking weird. I can't use my keyboard right now.
Oh, boy. Seems important.
Is your keyboard completely just bust right now?
It's convinced that I have control hold down at all times, I think.
Do you want to restart your computer quick, and we take a quick stop while you...
I probably should. I don't want to. But...
I need to order some dinner, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can take a 10-minute.
Yeah, this is a good moment. We got a corpse that I'm totally going to dump out of the box under the tree and then put the dirt back on top of once my little dude's done.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, I figured. By the way, I'm going to make sure and save every single Farm Rusher draw for this.
Good.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I'll let you use this as a chance to open all this stuff up and take a look at all this stuff. Yeah.
There's some really good draws.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to go restart my computer.
Yeah, you do that.
Stop that so it doesn't...
Okay.
All right, I'm back. I loaded everything up.
Cool.
Boop.
All right.
Great.
All right, what was the last fucking thing I did? Okay.
I was scratching a little bit at the canvas.
Yeah, that was what happened. Also, Bort was doing corpse stuff.
And I was asleep.
Well, right now, big Bort is digging a hole, little Bort is collecting coins.
Yes, that's right. I wanted to make sure that I could name him Little Bort, but unfortunately, every time I pressed my fucking L key, it locked my computer.
Yeah, that was weird.
Yeah, it was fucking weird. I had to restart my computer for some reason.
Yeah.
Computers are dumb.
It got excited.
Especially are dumb.
Yep.
Alright, yeah. Little Bort is collecting all the coins, and you are digging the hole and putting Gorgos back down into it.
Yep.
Alright, that's going to take a reasonable amount of time.
Yeah.
That's okay. It's starting night. It's getting pretty late.
Sucks to be you guys. One of us is basically immune to the elements.
Two of us.
Nice.
Yeah.
High five.
Well, so
I don't have so five.
Like, on the canvas,
whatever you have.
Occupied for a while.
Yep.
I'm probably gonna hang out here with the tree.
Wait, you've been scratching at the canvas?
A little bit. Just
lumpy.
To see. Yeah, it's lumpy.
Yeah. Well then,
he's just like going full hog on it. He's just poking at it.
No, he like, takes like a fingernail and like scratches it a little bit.
Yeah.
Well, you do rip the canvas.
Yeah.
There's nothing underneath there except a rock.
What's the rock look like?
It's just full of rocks.
It is a rock.
It
appears to be kind of like full of like pebbles and rocks to make a pattern or something.
Oh, okay. I don't scratch more.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody have a... Oh, who am I kidding? I have a pencil on me.
Of course you do. You have a pencil, a clipboard, and like a whole bunch of notes on you at all times.
Of course. All my trusted briefcase. Mm-hmm. So I start sort of sketching along, like, you know, the sort of thing where you do an imprint of a leaf.
Yep.
I just do that to the surface of the canvas.
Mm-hmm. I'm thinking of how that would look real quick. Yeah, that would work out. Okay. And what you have there is essentially what looks like another half of the map or something.
Excellent.
Yay!
You'll figure it out the minor easy puzzle.
Yay, now that I've woken up from my nap, I can actually be useful. Oh god, the tree!
What? Oh,
What happened with the tree?
Nothing.
Bye, tree.
That was not actually a thing. I was just talking with you.
All right.
Oh, okay.
Piece of shit.
All right, so are we burying this corpse right now?
Yep.
All right.
Working on it.
Hey, guys. Was Bartholomew Flamebeard even awake during all this?
No.
Nope.
Hey, Bartholomew Flamebeard, go get your shovel. We need to bury a corpse.
Okay.
Now, what in tarnation are all you doing up here?
A tree freaked the fuck out.
The tree freaked out?
Yeah, the tree freaked out. We don't know what was going on with it. It was weird.
Oh, I'm sorry. Takes off his hat, wiggles tentacles around. Why, I was jumping to a conclusion and was about to blame you for all of this trouble.
I'm a simple country Cthulhu.
Yeah.
Now, see, the roots burst open and this coffin just popped out and the body flew out. It was crazy. We're doing our best to get it back to normal.
I suppose that does happen occasionally.
It was very emotionally disturbing. I'm very emotionally disturbed.
Oh, I can imagine. Everyone liked Mr. George.
I just say, are you the three in charge? You know.
Are you the one that runs this purveying of sustenance for your collective?
What?
Is this your place?
Yeah!
Then we give these to you in tribute to your to bringing the collective its food. I'm gonna have a little board give them all the coins. Take these shiny medals in honor of your food services.
Well, why don't you come and stay at my place for the night? I'll treat your wife for this this payment.
That sounds nice. It's getting a little too dark to head back to the city.
Well, you can always head back to the city even during the dark. That place never sleeps.
I don't know. Weird stuff happens in the countryside at night.
That's also true. Let's go.
They say weird stuff happens in nowhere.
What could ever go wrong here? Did we finish burying that corpse, by the way, or did we leave it half done just to get the legs in the air?
I would hope that we got most of him buried. We're trying to feed the tree, after all.
Yep, just the shoes are hanging out.
just the hooves.
Yep. Save that one as well. Thank you, Rob Mosher. Well, you know how they say, si casa es your casa.
I'm sorry, I don't speak Elven.
That was Spanish, you goddamn idiot.
Does anyone know what Spain is?
Isn't that a type of fruits or something? I don't eat those.
That is the line of bones that run up your boned species things.
And your back. Spine board.
What? Right.
Yeah, that's what he said.
A Spain, yeah.
That makes sense.
All right.
I don't have one of those.
Uh-huh.
I'm supported by a system of fluid-filled sacs.
Oh, fluid-filled sacks. I got those too.
You guys like corn?
I do enjoy all corns. Maize, wheat, barley.
I like them on the cob.
I would like to roll some sort of perception check on this location.
I do also like the cob.
I would like to see...
A good sweet field corn cob, actually, is quite delicious.
I would like to perceive this place to see if it looks suspicious, also to see if there's any good-looking flies.
Of course.
Can I use... Okay. I'm going to use my frog background here. Is that okay?
Yes.
All right, so I'm going to roll d20 plus 5 plus 2. Oh, okay, yeah, no.
There are some sweet-looking flies. That is totally okay. You can find those flies.
Okay.
Otherwise, this looks like a barn.
Okay.
You've never seen one before, but you're pretty sure this is what one of these looks like.
Wait, did he take us into the barn or to the house?
To the barn house, come on.
The barn house. You know, okay. Barnhouse. He's a simple country Cthulhu.
Yeah.
Who might have been
straight
at
up,
the,
he brings you to the barn. Yeah, let's go with that. And he actually looks around. There's plenty of space for all you gentlemen. And, like, looks at Geros and Bort and Al and Bart. People love indeterminates. I never knew the difference personally. And just like looks on.
Oh, this is that other thing that you surface worlders call a gender.
What? Is that what it's called?
Close enough.
I don't have one, so do not worry.
I was talking more about your lack of face thingies.
Oh, you mean the tentacles?
No. I mean the other ones.
I got this beard.
That's not what I mean, you idiot. It just drags you to the hay. There's plenty of hay for all of us to sleep in. Good night. Just falls backwards, completely falls backwards onto its back. Just fucking dead.
How dead are we talking here?
He's completely stone still. Probably not actually dead. He's probably just hibernating or something, but falls on his back. Absolutely no preparation whatsoever. Completely got out.
Yeah, good enough. I do the same thing.
Nice. Al opens up his briefcase and pulls out a bedroll and an energy bar.
Hey, and wasn't this guy at the reading earlier? He looks familiar.
Was he?
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
That may have just been a clerical error.
I actually just checked. No, he was not.
Oh, uh-huh. He wasn't?
Yep.
Racist.
Ala eats the energy bar and kind of mumbles about.
It's true.
Corn.
You shouldn't expect him to be racist. He is. He is a wizard. Did you just whisper corn to someone?
No, I'm mumbling about corn passive aggressively because he said something about corn and then he just, you know, went to sleep.
I want
to
throw a cob at Al's head.
Ah.
Roll for initiative against corn.
You want right. Corn? Roll for initiative.
Okay, let's see.
Roll for corn initiative.
Don't actually do that.
That was a joke.
Yes.
I catch the corn.
Okay, yeah, that's probably a corn catch.
That's definitely a corn catch. Good job. You caught the corn. Do you eat the corn? This is very important.
When you put it that way.
I don't know if I just want corn that's uncooked.
Look, raw corn is perfectly fine, I hear.
It came from a frog.
You can try.
Little Bort just wanders over, picks up a corn, wanders over, starts eating it.
I could probably start a fire so we could actually cook or boil this.
Penny will start a fire.
Well, if I can cook the corn.
Shall I start a fire to cook the corn?
Shall you start a fire to cook the corn?
Shall you?
Look, we can eat raw corn if you want. I'm just offering.
Do you want to start a fire?
I am a wizard. Let's start a fire.
All right. Well, while they start a fire, I'm gonna. While you're starting that fire, I'm gonna tell you a little something about myself. Not only am I a fine frog, much known in the frog ways. I don't know if I mentioned that, by the way. Frogs, yes. I'm also a bard. Let me sing you a song of my people. Starts just croaking like crazy. Yes, like that. To no end other than just a song of his people.
25 to not burn down the barn, starting a fire.
Congratulations, you managed to avoid burning down the barn.
Hell yeah.
Yes, accomplishments.
You create like a little fire pit out of stones you find around.
I want to roll to see how good the song is turning out and how into everybody it is, everybody.
Okay, go ahead.
So that
your
will be...
song is so into us.
Yeah, hell yeah. So I'm going to apply my... do I apply charisma for this? I would think so.
Yes.
So 1d for 20 plus 5 plus 2 plus 5. Well, okay, here's a question here. Do I use frog or the inspirational croaking for monsters here?
That's an inspirational croaking.
Okay. So let's see what this gets.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah, okay.
Good croak.
As far as frog croaking goes, it's making a pretty good one right now.
The eyes hop out of the Lovecraft monster and, like, open up mouths. Hey, man, that's pretty good.
Thank you.
What's your name?
I am Geros. I'm a frog.
Ah, sweet. I eat frogs.
I'm going to leave the barn right now.
No, wait, I don't mean I'm going to eat you. I just do.
I'm leaving. I'm gonna go hang out with the corpse.
That's a good choice.
Bye, frog.
I think I ran that frog out. That's okay. Yeah, I just hop back into its head.
I'm over here by the corpse.
Okay.
Me being
the
an
night
old man,
passes.
Probably... I'm probably gonna.
When you wake up, the monster is no longer there because he is in fact a farmer and is probably working early in the morning.
All right.
So you got another section of map, and there's another little thinger there.
Okay.
Let's follow it.
Yeah, go do it.
Hey guys, I stole that Minotaur's hooves.
That is fucked up.
What?
Cut them off, of course.
You know, for luck. That's how you guys do things, right? Someone showed me this one thing with, like, rabbits, like, feet. That's the thing you guys do. That's lucky, right?
We don't do that to people.
What's people? It says the frog, kind of looking at him, honestly confused.
Something and stops.
I whisper to the frog, you should have dug the horns.
Oh, are those worth more?
Yes.
Oh, my bad.
As a wizard, in quotes, you would know.
Yes. As a wizard, I would.
I'm a wizard, and I think that's fucked up.
All right, so look at this map. It looks...
Next
does it
back in the city.
Next, back in the city? Okay.
Yep.
Should we go follow this thing?
Ow, give me a social knowledge, social worker check.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, what's that?
Whatever you want, dude. Just not strength, like physical ones.
Okay, any mental.
Yep. It's pretty good. You know exactly where that is.
Yeah, it's right over by
the pizza parlor.
Yeah.
It is right over by the pizza parlor. But in particular, where that is shit, what am I thinking of? Some kind of corporate building. Some kind of company there. It's a hotel, like, it is where an owner of hotels, like, works. I don't know where that would be. Assumedly at a hotel. Or at a building where they would manage those. I don't know if there's a difference between those two things, because I don't know much about hotels.
Interesting.
You understand what I'm getting at, though. It is a corporate office.
Sure.
Yeah.
So, should we go over to this thing, I guess?
Yeah, well, us hear, so, I mean...
We're all stuck together by the unity of all these crimes we've committed. By we, I mean I. So, you know,
my
let's go.
Hurts.
It was a shitty night's sleep. You were
also,
sleeping
I'm
lots
an old
of
man.
Eh, you're not as old as you look. You are a wizard, after all.
All right, so let's go to this place. Transition!
Woo, 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 woo!
Oh.
There, I fixed it. Oh my god, I did not check what Bart looked like at all when flipped. He looks terrible. You go back to your normal position. You piece of shit. Gross.
Wizards, man.
Yeah, that was a corporate tower. That's where you're going. What was his name? It's who's one off the top of my head. Okay. This is the head of where Mr. Sokolov works.
Mr. Sokolov Memorial Towers?
Sure. Sokolov Memorial Towers. This is actually the name of his hotel chain. The Memorial Towers.
I'm back.
Yep.
My pizza showed up. Well, my wings and cheese sticks, but you know.
Pretty much a pizza if you try hard enough.
Yeah.
We're at a hotel tower thing.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Welcome to the place where Mr. Sokolov of Sokolov Memorial Towers runs his hotel chain called the Memorial Towers, apparently.
Aha.
Mm-hmm.
Good to know.
Mm-hmm.
Al, do you know who this guy is?
Probably.
He's actually quite a philanthropist. He donates quite a lot to the city to help get things in order.
Mm-hmm.
So I earned him quite a lot of favor with a 3.
See.
Shall we go in?
Yeah, okay.
We could just stand here in front of the door.
Frog just walks in, puts the hooves on the counter. So, what do you guys know about... What's his name again?
George.
What's the name of the guy? George! Do you know George? Hi! I'm a frog.
Oh, bug on my window. Yeah, my monitor. Give me a second.
I cast Fireball on the bug.
No, fuck you. That bug didn't deserve that. What's wrong with you?
Roll initiative against bug.
I rolled a D100.
Alright, so okay, who's at the desk here? The desk inside. What's at the desk?
Alright, so at the desk is a, you know, standard model dwarf. You know, everyone has seen one of these. They're just fucking everywhere. You know. He's sitting at the desk. He is apparently some kind of secretary.
Okay, so the tablets didn't give us any sort of other hints about what we're looking at here, right? We're just, it's
yeah,
a
no,
location.
Just location, nothing else.
All right. Thinking for a sec. Hey, Mr. Dwarf Man, can we, like, talk to your boss?
Do you have an appointment, sir or madam?
I got these hooves.
Looks at the hooves and... Would you like to make an appointment, sir or madam?
Sure. All right.
Our nearest appointments are in the next 5 weeks. We have an opening on Saturday, 3 weeks from now, at midnight. That is the closest opening that you have.
I'll go back to Bort and Bart and Al. How do you guys think about that? 5 weeks? Is that cool?
In 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
We're racing against a few other people.
It's true.
I don't think we have the time.
I walk up to the counter and I say, look,
Hello, sir or madam.
Oh, there was up there.
Tempting, would you like to make an appointment?
What's the guy's name again that runs the place?
Mr. Sokolov, sir.
Well, Mr. Sokolov, may want to know that, Al, the champion of the underground, is, looking to say hello.
Well, flex your muscles here.
Okay.
Take a check to make sure that you can, like, recognize your name or something.
Yeah. Make myself look impressive enough, so I'm gonna roll, strength and,
You gotta literally flex in front of him?
Yeah, literally, like, you know, well, like, not like, you know, like, you know, put my arms up, like, buff up a little bit to, like, make it, you know, look, make myself look impressive.
Big guns. Rock them guns.
It's worthy to note that you are a kobold and thus, like, 3 feet tall.
Right, yeah, no, but I mean, a muscular 3 foot tall kobold.
Yeah, fair enough.
Like a tiny rip midget.
You were really good at rolling dice. Good job.
That's going to change when we get into combat.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You, unbeknownst to you, you flex up pretty hard. You flex up extra hard, and you, without really intending to do so.
Well, I can't quite control my own strength.
In fact, your shirt actually rips a little bit, and little lizard pecs just kind of like flex out.
Garrus is taking a little back. Oh. Steps back a little bit, like, what?
I'm sorry. I opened up my briefcase and pulled out into the church.
The dwarf actually looks down at you and... I'm not sure how to take this. Is this a threat? Or is this,
Wait, hold on.
Either way, I'm kind of into it.
Okay, hold on. I want to roll here. I want to roll. I want to start singing like some Kenny Loggins shit in the background here, or no, the most like romantic kind of shit I can in the background here. I'm gonna roll some. Yeah. So I'm gonna roll D20 plus my charisma plus frog. No, inspirational singing plus level. Okay, hold on.
Not everything can be done with plus frog.
Okay, I'm using.
Realize it should be able to.
I'm using inspirational singing for monsters here, though, because this is very inspirational.
Pretty good. Yeah. All right.
This is the way I planned this going, but I'll roll with it.
You may have had some help. Some druid help.
I'll pencil you in for 10 minutes from now.
Thank you, sir. Gives him a little wink as he rips his old shirt off to put on the new one.
That was a really hot lizard. I was more impressed than anything.
I didn't think kobolds could be that sexy.
Right, are we just gonna time flash to 10 minutes, or you want to do something before this?
Yeah, give me a few.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. Kind of like in a few minutes, he sends you kind of just go up. You know, you'll find it eventually.
I take my hooves with me.
No problem.
We go up.
Between.
We're going up. Hey, Bort, we're meeting this guy in the hotel thing. What did you?
I know. You went between.
So we go into the office.
Yeah, give me a second. I'm almost done.
Okay. All right. I didn't hear that you were working on that.
Hell yeah! Hell yeah!
Hi!
It's all you hear. It's kind of like it clacks at you.
Okay.
It is a spider.
This is his towers, I presume.
I guess I'll speak to the spider.
Hey, okay. That's a good way to skip past this.
he's an animal.
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Hi.
What is your business here?
I don't know. I'm going to turn to you. What are we doing?
We're looking for tablets.
Right. We're looking for tablets. Sir Business Spider.
Oh. Okay.
A minotaur died and... Yeah, I was sent on a quest to find his house.
Okay, yes, I understand. But, like, it just...
By that kobold over there.
I've had pedipalps a lot. You're one of the people who got picked up off the street, right? Okay.
That actually happened, yes.
It kind of like turns around very slowly because it's in a very cramped area.
A tiny little office.
Yeah, pretty much a tiny little office. It's a giant spider in like a normal office chair.
Business.
And, pretty much, I'm willing to bet it's wearing the suit, yeah. Turns around, roots around in the back with a giant bookcase. Okay, I don't know why I couldn't say the word bookcase.
It happens to all of us.
And hands you a book. Oh, I couldn't find the thing to turn it around, so just jump.
I'm going to hand the book to Al. Because I assume that he is literate.
There's a puzzle in there. I don't know about it. George was weird. Alright, I get the fuck out.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
I have an actual meeting in like 20 minutes.
Goodbye.
Thank you for your time.
No problem.
Geros resists his carnal urge to try to eat the spider and leaves.
It's a pretty good, pretty big spider.
The urge is pretty carnal and primal.
There is, in fact,
it's a sex
of,
thing.
not that kind of carnal, but sure.
On the way out of the building, I don't stop, but I say to the dwarf, actually, I just want to be friends. Bye.
No, that's actually cool with me. It's fine.
Geros does a wah, wah, wah. Wah. You pick that up on the street. He picks up a lot of things, like hooves.
No, he didn't pick those up off the street. You cut those off of a corpse.
Well, look, all things are up to interpretation. Truly, the ground is, in fact, trees, like, road, street. It's Tree Street. Tree Street, treat. USA.
A treat.
Yeah. All right, what's with the book, Al? What's with the deal?
Let's see the book. Uh-oh, it's that dude.
Swamps are for nerds.
All right, let's do this. I'm gonna try. Excuse me, sir. Get up in his face. Excuse me, sir. Let me tell you about swamps and how good they are. Okay.
How bad they are? You mean you say good, really, really fucked up ways.
Look, man, let me tell you about frogs. Once in the
beginning, I know plenty about frogs and their shit.
Let me tell you the good word about frogs.
Try.
I have tried. I tell them about frogs. Look, frogs are an amphibious species of creature.
Amphibious species of pieces of shit.
Oh God! I've been owned.
Y'all eat a dick!
So I'm taking a look at the book.
Bort, I swear to God, I am going to murder that guy. I swear to God. I don't know if you guys, like, if your peoples have murder or anything, but I'm going to murder that guy.
That's when killing has not been granted, right?
Look, killing that guy has been totally been granted. In fact, I am granting you the right later on to murder that guy. No. But anyways, book.
Bort, he doesn't have the authority to tell you to do that. Don't do that. Please don't do that.
I didn't think that he did, honestly.
Wizard knows things too about books, sure.
Yep. Let me see that book. What's in the book? Is there a map in the book?
A whole bunch of angsty teen poetry.
Fuck. Kids these days.
They don't know.
Alright. Let's try and decipher this poetry.
What's the poetry about? Is it about frogs?
Let me look under F. You don't want to know.
Oh.
It's about fucking.
I'm into it again.
So I don't know if I've got anything tied to poetry, but as a wizard, as a magically inept wizard, I am good at deciphering runes and complicated stuff like that.
You know, angsty teen poetry is pretty much basically the equivalent of magic runes. Okay.
It's not formally recognized as a form of magic. But,
there's an entire civilization of magical peoples out there who basically just write shitty poetry all day, every day, and that's basically just their entire language.
They're called bards.
Yeah.
Oh no, I've been owned again!
Alright. 19 to decipher poetry.
That's alright, I'll take it.
Wait. Ancient team poetry, that's kind of like swamps.
So, funny thing is that it's not the equivalent of a tablet or something, but you do, like, there are directions going on if you, like, take every first word of every poem in here.
The spider told me that it's a puzzle.
Yeah. Oh.
I should have probably brought that up.
Yeah. Basically, it's just a...
That would have saved some time.
Maybe.
It seems like Bart figured that out on his own.
I forgot it was important.
Yeah, not until I got to Section H.
Like, you find the words to the map to your soul in there somewhere, and, like, you figure out, wait, maybe I just take the word map in here, and hey, this works out. Something like that.
Alright.
What are the directions like?
They will lead you to a coast.
Well, it seems like we have another place to go. If we want to get this thing, which I don't technically believe in, but I like getting stuff, we should do that. We should do that thing.
We should. Let's go.
So do you not believe that the building exists, or do you just not believe that you should have the building?
I believe more in the... Well, I more just don't believe in it philosophically speaking.
Okay. That's less insane.
You know, religion. Am I right, fellas? Frog kind of taps, you know, little Bort on the shoulder. Yeah.
Yeah, this guy knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah, he knows what I'm all about.
We follow the instructions of a High Druid. Also,
I'm kind of just directing y'all as much as I want. I could just say you could have gone pretty much wherever you wanted, would have worked out, but I've decided to give you some direction if you wanted it. So, I will ask you here and now, do you want to go to the coast, or do you want to do something before you go to the coast?
We're following the map.
I think we're just following, I think we should just continue following it. I mean, it's not like I don't think there's anything immediately that we need to do first, other than maybe punch that fucking nerd in the face.
I don't know, I was thinking you might want some shawarma or something.
I'm gonna stop by a tavern and get some alcohol to go.
Oh. It's actually not allowed in Drakkenhall. You're not allowed to just carry, booze with you openly, unfortunately.
It's not going to be openly. I'm going to throw it in a bag.
Exactly.
All right, fine.
I'm going to look around for the nearest person that looks really easily... let me figure out how to phrase this. Who's the biggest schmuck around?
Well, of course, it's going to be this guy right here.
Oh man, that guy is insanely cool.
He's insanely cool. Hell yeah.
Excuse me, good sir!
Hell yeah, dog, what's up? Give me some skin.
You give him a little bump, yeah.
Yeah.
So, tell me, sir, have you heard the good news?
I hear good news every day. Yep.
Well, let me tell you some new good news. The best news you have ever heard in your un-life. Let me tell you about...
Cool, dog. I would have taken life, too. I'm not exactly narrow-minded.
Yeah, that's cool. But let me tell you something. Let me tell you about frogs. Now look.
I'm cool about frogs. Come on. Teach me what I need to know about frogs.
Okay. I'm a frog, right? But let me tell you
Hell
something.
Yeah. Give me some skin.
Yeah, give me some skin. Now, let me tell you something, sir. Not only can I be a frog, you too can gain and gain the assets and learn to appreciate the wonders of frog.
Hmm. You make an interesting case, little frog.
So let me tell you something. Frogs can regenerate wounds after all times, kind of like skeletons.
I can do that.
Frogs can exhibit and you know, exhibit amphibious nature. So they can live in water and above the water, kind of like skeletons.
Just misfunctionally deleted your token, right?
Oh, it's still there.
Because I couldn't grab it. You keep out of there. Try to enter the void space at the end of time. Please avoid doing that. I know you're a wizard and that's like your end goal, to enter the void space at the end of time, but don't do it right now.
All right.
I'll keep myself under control. All
right. So I want to try converting the skeleton to frog now, basically. I want to roll to see if I've converted him to that old frog time religion.
Yep. However, if you roll poorly, he might try to convert you to becoming a skeleton.
The secret thing is, frogs are already into skeletons, or skeletons are already into frogs. Have you learned anything from dissections?
Well, of course. You're really fucking good at this. Yeah, dog. Being a frog sounds like it's completely owned.
So you should go live your life as if you were a frog, and also spread the good word about the frog to all the non-frog believers. Tell them to believe in frog. Tell them to believe in all the things that frogs do. Because if you believe in a frog will believe in you.
Yeah! Tears off his clothes and just like fucking explodes into a fireball with a frog at the end of it.
All right.
And just goes like flies off into the distance.
Well, I've done my good deed for today. How you doing, Al?
You know, living in Drakkenhall isn't exactly normal, but you're really weird.
I was fucked up.
Look, man, it's religion.
Frogs will fucking cut you wide open.
I grew up in a bog. Let me tell you something. Bogs? Drakkenhall's got nothing on a bog.
So...
I do like a good bog. Very moist.
Whoa, what?
The ocean.
Oh, we're on the coast now.
You know, with the 30-foot starfish.
World's largest starfish, all right? Just let it happen.
Is there a sign next to that says, "See, the world's largest starfish"? Woo!
I'm more interested in the orb.
Ignore that orb.
Do not look at the orb in the corner. Pay no attention to the orb.
I'm gonna worship this orb. No, the orb is gone.
You killed
it. No! I hope I ate it.
You didn't.
Oh.
You didn't get the chance.
I'm gonna eat me a starfish.
That's okay. There's plenty there. Oh, you're on the coast, and... Hey, what do you think all you are doing here?
Following the map.
Huh.
I just saw those guys.
How you been? Little Bort didn't make the transition. Oh no.
Oh shit, I gotta fix that.
Wait a minute. I thought those guys said there could only be teams of four.
Shit, you're right.
No, that's not what. No, they need to turn upon each other to determine who gets to be the fourth person.
One of them just vanishes from reality. Good job.
I wanted to see them turn against each other in a giant like melee.
Unfortunately, that guy logically just ceased to exist because of it. He had his own name.
Scary thing.
That was his name. The fifth man.
No, it was Equien.
Little Bort is technically an extension of me.
Also, as it's been established, we don't follow the rules.
What?
Yeah, the rules. We don't follow.
So wait,
Loose there were multiple paths to get here.
Yes.
I mean, yeah.
There's like four.
That makes sense because, like, if you had multiple teams and you had to have each thing, no one would ever get here because they'd a different part of the map, and then this challenge would be meaningless.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like being a frog, really, when you think about it.
Hell yeah! Takes it as a compliment.
Huh.
All right, so how do these guys look like? Are they looking ready to show down here? Like, what's the deal?
They are totally, like, flexing nuts and pumping up. They are totally ready to get into a big throwdown here.
All right. How you guys feeling about this? Are you guys willing to throw down? If you want to take the high road here.
Are we in the city limits?
No.
Okay, so we don't have to worry about getting in trouble.
That's ever stopped us.
Gonna break the law, but who's gonna find out?
I mean, yeah. Okay. Are these guys does any of these guys happen to be wanted criminals?
Let me check my notes here.
I'd say NBA Jam is wanted for not liking frogs.
What? Nah, well, okay, that's not illegal. I'm sorry. Technically, racism isn't illegal when you get down to it. It happens everywhere.
Thanks, Obama.
But on the other hand, he's also just a normal guy, honestly. He's not illegal or anything. Not illegal or anything. Yeah, good job. He has not committed any notable crimes. On the other hand, Ghostface Thrilla appears to in fact be a criminal of some kind.
Who looks like the...
Then they're all his accomplices. Let's bring him in.
Can social workers do that?
No.
Citizens can. Citizens arrest.
In fact, not a cop.
Wait, can I really quick, okay, can I do a perception to see who looks like the weakest?
Like most social workers totally thinks he is.
Is there anyone here who looks particularly like weak willed or like looks really like they're not actually a part of the criminal element?
Probably be NBA Jam, really.
Okay.
On the other hand, he doesn't like you.
Then all the more reason for me to do this. I'm gonna go walk up to him. I'm gonna throw the hooves on the ground, like in front of him. You see these? Yeah. Yeah, you best watch yourself. You best watch yourself. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Watch yourself, NBA Jam. Yeah, yeah. Okay. I pick up the hooves again, by the way. I don't want to leave those. They might be useful later.
Just, like, looks around and shrugs and let's go.
Okay, so then roll initiative.
Hell yeah, dog. I put everyone on. I should probably give these guys their real names because these are very long.
Yeah, that probably would help if you gave actual names.
This guy's Abhishek.
Aren't Rakshasa like an endgame anime? And
well, he's very enthusiastic, but really incompetent.
There we go.
That's Master Thrilla. Going from one Wu-Tang man to another.
Don't know why that rolled. So we're rolling initiative?
Hell yeah. Let's see.
Okay.
So where do I see? So is it plus your initiative then? So D20 plus your initiative, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
It's plus, basically dexterity plus level.
Dexterity plus okay, because I'm looking at my character sheet there, and it's so dexterity plus level. Okay, gotcha. Sorry.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sure. D20 plus 5.
So I'm gonna choose the 18. Quick to fight.
Congratulations, Zorak. You go one before me.
Oh, did you also roll a one? Oh no.
No, I just don't have any dexterity, dog.
Yeah. Word. That's cool.
Geros is quite busy with his threats and dancing around.
He's too busy sorting out the hooves, putting them like behind a nice rock. They don't get away. Yes, this might be useful later.
Sir. I'm just slow. Big mushroom guy. I don't need to worry about it. I'm big and strong.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna fuck him up with magic when
he
comes to my
turn. Numbers. I know Geros got 6.
I got a 5.
Nice. Oh.
18.
4 24. Is like 5, but I should have one more, yes.
Al had 24.
Okay. Al is pretty fast. Interesting facts. Fast facts about kobolds. They're pretty fast. This is fucking super lopsided. Holy shit. PCs always go first in cases of draws. And there you go. Okay, Al. It's up to you. You go first. Also, give me a second.
Launch all zig.
Wait, what's that? What's with the crucifix in the left and the orb?
Currently, the escalation die is at 0.
Yeah.
Up on the number.
Cool.
I don't know what that means.
Escalation die is something that you add to your attack rolls.
Every turn,
at the end of every turn,
one.
It goes up by 1. Yes. Which makes it so it's more likely for you to, as the match goes on, it's more likely for you guys to actually end it.
Aha.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right. So
these distances are close enough that you can always close in on one movement.
Yeah. So Al puts down his briefcase and loosens his tie.
Mm-hmm.
Then he uses Springing Mantis Strike.
Springing Mantis Strike.
And as part of the standard, runs up to Master Thrilla, because he is
the criminal.
The criminal.
The prime offendant.
Oh, right. I should put on tunes for this.
Yeah, it's a little too mellow.
Yep.
Need some like a Mortal Kombat theme or something.
So that's going to be... Thirteen against AC.
Against Master Thrilla?
Yes.
13?
Mm-hmm.
13 fails to hit, you piece of shit.
Alright, the worst. 2 miss damage, I think.
2 to miss damage? Okay.
I don't know if... It. Actually, it doesn't say 2 miss damage, so I don't think I do.
You absolutely do. It is a melee attack.
Alright.
All right, you're done. Now it is time for Abhishek. What the fuck can you even do? It's been a while since I made you.
Mortal Kombat.
Okay. That's actually not a good idea right now, so... the thing that he's going to do is the thing that he's worst at. And he's actually just going to go ahead and walk up to you and, like, punch you. Hit you with a stick. That's all. Ooh, 16 to hit your AC.
Ties.
Ah, okay. That means he hits. Yes.
Yes.
You only take 2 damage.
Oh boy.
He is not very good at hitting things.
I'll mark that damage.
Now, on the other hand, the hothead. Womph. Now,
I have a procedural question real quick, actually.
What's up?
We have no way of knowing what their HP is, correct?
You can see their bars, don't they? Can't you?
Nope. I see a green bar. I can't see what it actually is, though.
Yeah, well, you can see the bar, and...
There it is.
I'm just saying, because I have certain like abilities that can only do stuff against people with certain like HP...
Yeah.
So do I just have no way of knowing without asking you?
You could ask me. You could, honestly.
Or I'm just not sure if procedurally I'm supposed to be like figuring like it probably has 40 HP or.
Nah, you're really supposed to know what their HP is.
Okay,
honestly.
That's fair. I'll just curious.
Yep. Whenever you want to, just ask me because I'm not gonna read them off right now.
Sure. Yep. Don't worry. No problem.
So Hothead shows up. kind of like zooms over. He's a fire elemental, obviously. Flies over, like leaves a trail of steam on his way, and he shoots out a blazing cone against 1d2 plus 1 enemies. So, against 2 enemies, which will be Geros and Bart. Mm-hmm. Oh, that hits either of your physical defenses.
Yep.
Congratulations. You both take 8 damage.
Alright.
He takes... No, that's not what I wanted to do. He takes 12 damage for doing that.
Alright, I have updated. Ow.
Did he just wreck, like, rip a part of himself off?
Pretty much. He, like tears off a bit of his arm and just fires it all over you.
That seems dumb.
Yeah, it's pretty dumb. Honestly. He's not very smart.
Nope.
Bart, get in there.
Alright, I'm going to respond to that with... I am going to... Let me set this up. I am going to cast Scorching Ray, by which I mean I chuck a knife at the dude.
It's a very hot red-colored knife.
Against which guy are you throwing it at?
Just, I was throwing it at Hothead. Sorry. 12 against his AC.
Ah. You fail to do anything. Got it.
All right, he takes 2.
See, good job. The thriller is here. Yeah, yeah, you see this? He can do that to you. How do you feeling? How are you feeling?
Yeah, he keeps his hands up and follows him around.
All right, so what he does is he like grabs onto like the little bit on the end of his mask and he tears it up and he unleashes his vile spew.
Oh God!
I had a girlfriend that did that once.
13 versus your physical defense.
I believe that is a miss.
Oh, I'm sorry. You don't take anything. Congratulations. The spew just kind of like. Lands harmlessly into the water. It's really gross, but thankfully it doesn't touch you at all.
Just kind of matrix dodge out of the way a little bit.
He will attempt to disengage from you. He succeeds on doing so.
Alright.
Geros, it's up to you.
Oh, I'm up. Okay, let's see.
You shitty frog.
Yeah, that's a quick action. All right. So quick actions take place before like normal actions, correct?
They take place whenever you want, dude.
Okay. I'm just thinking. I just didn't remember how this whole combat stuff.
Action order goes however you want, unless it specifically says it.
I'm just making sure. So quick action doesn't replace like an actual attack action or anything like that. Mm-hmm. It's its own separate thing.
Yep.
Okay. So quick action. I'm going to do. My, let's see, Song of Heroes, which is a bardic song. Let's see. I'm not sure what I actually have to roll to do this. Let me take my character sheet real quick. Actually, it says 11, it has a sustain, so I'm just allowed just to do this, actually.
Mm-hmm. There we go. That's more appropriate. No, that is not the one I was looking for. Damn it. It's the chiptune version. I don't want that. Fuck that.
So I believe as an opening action, since it's my opening turn, it means me and my nearby allies get a plus one attack bonus until the start of my next turn. For the opening.
Mm-hmm.
So that means Bart, Bort, and me get plus one to attack.
Okay.
Is that just physical attack or ranged and physical attack, I guess?
That's just attacks in general.
Yep, it's all things. It's yep. Song.
Is that all allies or nearby allies?
It's nearby allies.
Gotcha. So that would be Bort and Bart.
Yep.
Yeah.
So Bort and Bart and Little Bort all I sing a song about how great frogs are and how shitty this elemental is.
Yep.
It's yeah.
Really inspiring.
It's this really inspiring.
Really shitty.
Yeah. All you guys are like, man, yeah, screw that guy. But I am going to use my daily.
Really?
Okay. Well, I don't know.
It's up to you.
I'll go ahead at you. I'll just open up with my my battle chant. I'll sing of the glories of the frogs and also just, you know, summon some fucking lightning on the hotheads, but
okay, good job. I like it.
Let's see, that's charisma plus level versus MD. So just see. So it's 1d20 plus that? I'm just not too familiar with how you do this actual thing. So.
Okay. Your thinger is you're using the thunder thinger, right?
Yeah, the battle chant or whatever it's called.
All right.
MD, so it's plus 7.
I have written down what your number is as is. Yeah, 1d20 plus 7 versus mental defense of a nearby enemy.
Yeah, 1d7 plus... 1d7 plus... No, 1d20 plus...
1d20.
Plus level. Plus what is it plus 7?
Because it's your charisma plus level.
Oh, you're right, yep. 1d20 plus 7, yep. You're right, sorry. 18.
Hey, that definitely hits Hothead, who has not got good mental defense.
Okay, and then I deal 1d6 plus charisma, which is 1d6
5.
Plus 5, yeah. I deal 11. Wait, did that work right? Yeah. Oh, I got a perfect 6. Yeah.
Nice. Whoa, he is hurting real bad. You just lightened the fuck out of this guy.
Okay. I had my turn.
Good. You piece of shit. I hate it. The turn was awful.
It was great. Some Chrono Trigger ass move actions.
Hi.
You are a piece of shit. And I hate you.
It's a bit rude.
He is done for his turn because whenever he moves, he has to move real far. Bort.
He's all up in my face, I guess.
And he is large, so he is difficult to disengage from.
What do I care?
That's only if you wanted to.
Well, I'm just going to breathe real deep and then hit him with my gust.
Gross.
So that's going to be 21 versus his PD.
Oh, you destroyed it.
So he takes 3d6 damage plus 5 ongoing cold damage.
Whoa. 6.
So
that's
that was
six.
Yep. Let me just roll an additional d6 because I hit the wrong button. So that's going to be nice. 12, and then 12, he'll continue.
And every turn he'll take an additional 5.
Yep.
I believe that save ends. Might not be. I don't know.
I don't know. It doesn't say on here. Well, my ripping vines say that, so I don't believe so.
All right.
Because they're just, they're chilled.
Before
like
rolling, you can take a free disengage attempt if you want.
Okay.
Yep.
I don't
just
know what
roll
that...
a d20.
Okay.
It is particularly hard to disengage from him, but if you roll it over a 14, you're good.
I rolled a 3.
You're staying where you are.
Yeah,
you
whatever.
Take an attack. Al, it's up to you. Also, dies at 1.
Alright, so, quick question about disengaging. Can you only do that once per turn per enemy, or is it anytime you have a move action?
Anytime you have a move action, I'm pretty sure. No, actually, no. It's straight up, you do it once per turn, unless you get a free one.
Okay. Then I'm going to, use the pincer whirls shut against, Abhishek.
Okay, go ahead.
You know what I just remembered? I forgot to have you guys do the plus one.
Hmm. It didn't end up mattering.
Oh, well, I meant for the, yeah. Is that to hit or is that to damage? I don't know.
I believe it's to hit.
If it says attack, then just hit.
Okay, sorry. Never mind.
Yep.
Okay. 16 against AC.
Yeah, he's a squishy wizardman, so absolutely.
And does not even roll, so I cannot roll to disengage to free, but I still do damage, so... Oop.
What's your damage, son?
13 damage.
Oof. That's a lot of damage, dang.
And I'm gonna roll to disengage.
You are rude as hell.
I disengage.
Yeah, you do.
Get the and fuck I jump over him and I move over to Master Thrilla.
Piece of shit. How else is he going to spew? Come on.
That's my turn.
Okay. Abhishek, it is time to fire the nonsense laser. Alright, I'm going to have to roll.
It's time for a rack attack for the Rakshasa.
This is... Mental Eruption!
Does he make those sound effects with his mouth?
Yes. Alright. If your mental defense is lower than 15, you are confused.
It's a tie.
And that applies to everyone, including my
own. What was the number?
If you have lower than 15...
What if you tie 15?
Then you get hit. Sorry. You need to have more than 15 to have avoided getting confused.
What's the symbol that we're using for confused?
Don't worry about it.
Because I'm hella confused.
All of my dudes are also confused, except for him.
Oh. Well, there you go.
Like I said, he's incompetent.
I'm gonna use this open up skull as confused. Mm-hmm. That seems pretty confusing. Is it no damage? Just confuses everybody?
Just confusion.
Okay.
Alright, hothead. You can't make opportunity, blah blah blah. Your next action will be a basic or at will attack at least one of your nearby allies, usually determined randomly. So, hothead attacks Gazer. You know, as you do. By punching him with his fists.
Flame fists.
Yeah, they're actually the red hot ram fists.
Okay.
That's how I wrote them down. Right, where the fuck is this? Whoa, both of those were 16 plus. What the fuck is wrong with me? That does 20 damage.
Wow.
Damn.
Hothead is kind of a hothead.
Yeah. On a 16 plus, that attack does 5 more damage, when normally it only does 5. So he can do anywhere from 0 to 20 damage with that. Hothead, what's wrong with you, you piece of shit? Bart, you must attack Bort with a melee attack.
There's also Little Bort.
You don't want to attack Little Bort. He's cute.
Also, he doesn't have combat stats.
Yes.
All right, and I'm... 16?
Yes.
All right.
Thankfully, he is... No, wait, no, you're a rogue, technically, so...
Yes, I am technically a rogue.
My AC is garbage.
Everyone's AC is garbage.
Yeah.
And does the escalation die affect damage?
No.
Yep. Doesn't it?
It does not.
12 damage.
Ow.
That is a lot of damage.
I just kind of stab you with a knife.
You think you're stabbing, I don't know, Abhishek or something, but you're totally stabbing Bort. You piece of shit.
What the fuck?
I'm just a scared old man.
Do we have to do a... Is this like a sustained, or do we have to do a save against this?
This only happens for one turn.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. This is a silly gimmick that I wanted to
How many
have.
Points did you do?
12.
12? 12. Mm-hmm. I took away 14. I am bad at things.
Master Thrilla. I don't have any new rallies. Alright.
Al is between him and Abhishek, technically, so...
Yeah, so actually, Thrilla just doesn't attack anyone, but instead just falls on his face and starts, like, doing a sand angel in the dirt under the water.
Ghost-faced Thrilla. Mm-hmm.
Geros.
Alright, so...
You can attack either of these two. Let's roll to see who you do.
One for...
Who wants to be one? Who wants to be two?
Bart will be one, Bort will be two.
I'll do the opposite, because fuck you.
Okay.
That means it's Bort.
Oh no, Bort.
Awesome.
Bort or Bart?
And for the basic, I just have to roll 1d20 to see if I hit?
1d20 plus your dexterity or your strength plus 2.
Wait, I'll do strength then. Ha 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 ha!
Plus 1, because you're... Actually, plus 2 again, because I think that thing applies to you as well.
Oh, God, great. Yeah, so I'm going to hit him totally.
Just roll like shit.
Yep, no, fuck, nope. Wait, actually, question. Mm-hmm. Shouldn't I be... I have my Song of Heroes that I technically need to sustain. Does it automatically fail?
No, you're good. That'll keep
well, I have to roll to sustain
really...
it.
Oh, try it.
Because if it doesn't sustain, something happens.
Yeah, well, go ahead and
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, you have to roll to sustain.
It sustains, actually.
Okay. It's really confused for a little second there. Like, you kind of mondegreen up the lyrics a little bit and fill it up with cromulent words, but it still works out fine.
Okay. So let me... So that totally is hitting, and then what is my attack damage-wise? It is just...
Totally pretty shit. It should be 2d something. I bet 2d6 in your case.
Yeah, it's 2d6 plus 3, yeah. Plus 3, and I think that's it.
Roll max. Pretty close to fucking max! Okay, you do even more damage than Bart does.
Fuck.
You piece of shit.
God damn it. Confusion's hell of a drug.
Kinda is.
Peace, Bart.
Oh god.
He's still alive, you're good.
I have 2 hit points.
Gazer Stern. Thankfully, he has to attack Hothead. Alright, so Gazer is going to do a sweeping grab. And totally hits.
Does he burn his hands?
And he does a hurling toss.
Doesn't he take also sustained damage from
yes,
Bort?
Yes, he will.
He does, yes. Alright.
And he just grabs the elemental and fucking throws him across the world, and that totally kills him.
Rip,
he looks like he hits this rock and just bursts into bursts into nothingness. He burns out right then and there.
Eat it, nerd! Sorry.
All right, Bort.
Since you're still
Bart.
Confused, I think you just yelled that at me.
Bort got attack Bart. Either with a basic attack or some kind of at-will attack.
He's eating a wing.
I'm taking 11.
Yep.
The best way to do damage is to make sure that everyone does damage to themselves.
All right. Ow.
Did you actually make those macros, or are you just using the ones built in?
I'm using the ones built in.
Oh, I didn't know you could do that. Huh.
I didn't know there was. All right.
There's a whole bunch on that character sheet.
Huh.
You should totally pop that character sheet open, and you can even pop it into its own window, and it's got all sorts of stuff.
Yep. Huh. Well, I'll be.
Nearby allies.
There are no nearby allies, so you basically have to do something stupid.
Okay.
Do something stupid.
Alright, then I'll just do a whole bunch of kung fu moves in place.
Mm-hmm.
and do like flips and shit, but like not actually hit anybody. Just, you know, spend like 20 seconds. Well, like, you know, the entire round just
like. And then the Wu-Tang Clan emerge from the ground and nod approvingly before descending back into the earth.
Which breaks my flow, so thanks for that.
Hey, sweet. I pulled something. I did something cool and ruined your class.
Yes.
All right.
Happy well, that's my turn.
Yeah.
So confusion ends.
Confusion ends. Everyone is no longer confused. However,
ooh. Incompetent mind blast.
Oh, great.
20 plus 7.
We wiped this.
You won't. Don't worry. Oh, you got incredibly lucky. He just hits Master Thriller with this, but not you.
Hey, great.
All right.
He fumbled on the one on me, I think.
Okay, so Master Thriller takes 10 damage, and Abhishek takes a d10. Oh, he takes 1. Okay. Good. Working out. He stands up on the rock because he wants to be cool. Always wants to be cool. Bart, you are in control again.
I just realized I forgot something.
What's up?
It doesn't matter, but it's pretty funny.
Good.
I'm just going to call attention to it anyways because it's pretty funny. So technically when I hit Bort, technically I should have gotten a battle cry to also heal Bort.
Nice. Do it. No, go ahead and do it. Do
so, because I got a 11 plus on my attack, I could get to do a battle cry to regenerate like the frog. Nice. Ally gets recovery plus 1d4 times escalation die, which was 1 then.
Yes.
So I'm going to heal Bort after punching him, by the way.
Good. All right, so you get to spend a recovery. You know how to do that, right?
Nope, not a clue, but I've got a button.
Yeah, roll the button.
You get that plus 1d4 times escalation.
Okay, so I'm going to hit this button.
All right, so you get a whole lot of health back. You get 19.
Jesus Christ.
And you've spent...
Plus one. Are you right?
You're down to 7 recoveries, right, right. But you gain 19 health back.
Well, it kind of changes my thing.
I think I actually gave you a net gain.
You did, yes.
Yeah, you did.
Sorry about that!
that actually was very helpful.
Okay, Bart, question. You want to do something?
Yeah, question. Is the escalation die at 1 or 2?
It's actually at 2 right now. You're right. Yeah.
All right, plus 9. So I am going to cast Cat's Grace as I just run up to the guy and try to stab him with a 14.
Mm-hmm. So what does the escalation die do?
It adds the bonus to your attacks.
Oh, okay.
Doors only. It does not apply to NPCs, to enemies. With
at least at this level, doesn't.
And there are certain abilities also that add certain stuff based off the escalation die as well.
Cool.
Or some things can only be used when the escalation die is at certain numbers. Like,
okay.
So it can only be used when it's at even, stuff like that.
Sweet.
Yep.
Works so 14 to hit?
14 does not
AC.
Hit at all his AC. All
right, he takes 2 damage, and I get to make a disengage check at a plus 5.
Okay.
Because I've renamed all my rogue attacks as wizard spells.
I understand. I understand your gimmick. It's a good one. Don't worry about it.
Disengage. Yep.
You succeed. Congratulations. If you did not have plus 5, you would have failed.
I have totally played this gimmick before. It's great.
I pop free on the other side.
Good.
Master Thrill's turn.
Vile spew.
Quit doing that. It's gross.
Oh, shit. Damn it.
Did you fuck something up?
So because Abhishek rolled a 1 around Master Thrilla, he gets a, he takes an amount of damage from his vile aura. Sorry.
He was out of combat anyways.
These guys are bad teammates.
Oh yeah, they're terrible. I made sure they would like.
Unlike us, we're great. All us, we've been punching each other the entire battle.
Nobody else caused that. We don't naturally just completely screw each other if we stand near each other for a length of time.
Yep.
Yeah.
Master Thrilla uses his wicked sight.
20 versus your armor class, Al.
That hits, but I'm gonna use evasive. Reroll.
Ah, you piece of shit. 23!
Okay, yeah.
Oh,
Zeus. Oh, nerd. That hits.
All right, so you only take 2 damage.
Oh.
However, really? You also take 4 ongoing save ends.
Okay.
Because you just got super poisoned right there.
Oh, whoops. I don't
want to. Whoa, that was the wrong direction.
That's a little much. Okay.
Yes.
So, you
only take the ongoing damage at the start of your turn. And you can save it.
I mark ongoing.
Don't bother. I'll reserve.
Okay. Also, what is the blue number on our character?
That is your number of recoveries.
Ah, okay.
If you look at Bort, he has 1 less because I marked it down for him.
No, okay. Recoveries for charge on a daily basis, right?
No.
Or is it per battle? Or is that total?
Recoveries are actually every 4 fights.
Ah, gotcha. Gotcha, yep. gotcha.
So on average, you should be using 2 per fight, pretty much.
Sure.
You guys are actually going to be coming out ahead on this. So... Geros.
Okay, so first off, I'm going to roll a d20 to see if I sustain this +1 that everybody's getting.
Yep. You can also willingly end it whenever you want.
I failed the sustain, so as a final verse effect, I get to this really good part about how great frogs are. Like, frogs really good! Don't forget it, nerd! One ally of my choice gets a +2 bonus to their next attack during the battle.
Yeah.
Which means I'm going to have... It's not even nearby ally.
I think. Oh, not even there?
I don't believe so. At least in the text I have copied over. It says just one ally. I'm going to give that over to Al.
Okay.
Al gets like all of a sudden inspired by how good frogs are. He's finally getting a little turned around, maybe. It's kind of like, I don't know.
Now that I think about it, frogs ain't half bad.
let's see.
Actually pretty cool.
So am I attached right now, or am I engaged with Gazer?
Yes.
Yeah, you are.
All right, so should I take out fight Gazer here, or should I take out Abhishek at this point?
Well, you know what you're capable of doing.
I can teleport, yeah, that's what I was thinking.
You're able to do a cosmic hop.
Yep.
And you can do that once per battle. So
yeah, I'm just trying to think if I want to take on Gazer or if I want to take out Abhishek. So technically, even though I'm engaged with Gazer, most of my attacks are ranged anyways.
Believe it or not, there actually is a question about that, if they're close quarter spells or not.
I've got like an air battle, my battle chance range at will. Mm. Well, I guess though it's technically one nearby, so Abhishek is a little bit ways away.
It's a question. I don't remember exactly.
Are Bort spell, so Bort, do you, or Tears, do you have long range spells or something?
Yes.
Okay, I'm just trying to think if I should take out Abhishek so he doesn't like nuke Bartholomew.
Yeah, I've got everything left that I can do is ranged.
Okay, I'm just thinking like if I leave Gazer fighting you, are you going to get owned?
No, I can do it. I can. I think
because Gazer's going out immediately after me, basically.
Yeah, so, I mean,
because I could take out Gazer and then you could take out Abhishek theoretically.
My thing totally says ranged versus nearby enemy, so I'm not really sure what that means on the range.
Well, it's kind of relative speaking.
I think so.
Yeah. So I think.
Yeah, I think we're all nearby each other.
Yeah, there's kind of like 3 levels of distance is how it works out. There's far away, nearby, engaged.
Okay.
So if it's nearby, I wouldn't be able to hit Gazer because it's ranged versus nearby then. So I'd have
because
to dump
it. It's not a close quarter spell, that is correct. If it was, you'd totally be able to hit him.
You should probably deal with Gazer and I can deal with Abhishek.
Okay. I'm going to see, unfortunately, my spells are all ranged nearby, so I can't. I'm engaged with Gazer, so I can't actually hit him with my ranged. So I'm gonna have to use a basic melee then.
You can also just disengage or try to.
Can you do that pre-disengage check or?
Well, yeah. You can willingly take an attack if you want. If you just want to always get out of the way.
Oh, why don't I just? I'll use my dimensional leap, and then I'll go ahead and
That will work out. Yeah. Go ahead.
Also, yes, you can teleport.
Yep, so I am going to use my cosmic leap and whoop, warp through existence over here. Like, dang, that was sweet.
That was sweet.
Y'all see that? It was fucking great. All right, I'm going to go ahead and use my battle chant. I'm going to shoot some lightning at Gazer.
Bullshit.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Fuck, no.
I was. Someone, Schwartz, just linked something that's completely fucked up wrong.
What?
Japan just announced that May 9th is.
What? What? What?
Fuckers.
May 9th has been declared as Goku Day in Japan. This is Piccolo Day!
Fuck that.
Fuck that. Well,
stream over.
Alright, okay, sorry.
I'm just tearing off my hair and we're going home.
Okay, I'm gonna have to address this on Twitter after the fact. But, okay, back to the thing at hand, sorry.
Ugh. Yes.
Okay. So, that is charisma plus level versus MD, so just roll 1d20.
Oh, his MD is 10, you're not gonna miss.
Yeah, 1d20 plus 7. 7 plus 2? That's right. So yeah, actually I have a really high. I have a plus 9, so unless I roll a natural...
Literally one. Impossible to miss unless you roll a 1.
Yep.
Which is always a miss.
Okay, so 13. I hit. And then it is 1d6 plus charisma. All right.
There is a non-zero chance you will not kill him. Or, you know, if you're not wanting to kill these guys, and you can run rule it out wherever 9. You want. You do exactly enough. Congratulations.
No, I'm fucking vaporizing his ass. Fuck him.
Oh, no.
No!
Yeah, fuck it. Just turns to fucking ash.
That'll
just command
man
at him.
And as a free action, I give Abhishek what equivalents to the frog version of the finger.
It's just the finger. It's just you have 4.
It's very... Well, yeah.
Depends on the frog type.
Yeah. I give him a rude gesture with my arms. All right, and that's my turn.
The arm pump.
Yep.
Bort.
Oh. I'm gonna fucking blast vines at Abhishek.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm gonna do my version of what the tree did.
It's like, yeah, I saw this one earlier. Check this out.
It was like seaweed or something, I suppose, here.
Whatever. I just do my grand gesture of just pulling my hand up and shit just comes out of the ground at him. Eat it, nerd.
He is a huge nerd.
1d20 plus 6... 17 versus his PD.
Totally hits. You're adding the plus 2 from this right over here, right?
19 versus his PD.
Yes.
No. 7 damage.
Wow. And that was an odd hit, wasn't it?
Yes. So he takes an ongoing 3.
Yep. Alright.
Because I am apparently the king of ongoing damage.
That's useful, trust me.
Yep. No, I am. It's useful in every game. I'm in.
All right, Owl's up.
Owl's up.
You have how much health does Abhishek have?
5.
Yeah, if you take out Abhishek, you might be able to have Bart take out, or at least incapacitate Ghost or Master Thriller. I keep wanting to say Ghostface Thriller.
Well, that's because that was what his name was originally.
No, that's right.
He was the Ghostface Thriller, and then he became Master Thriller. He migrated over one Wu-Tang.
Okay.
Well, okay. I'll let the dice decide. Let's roll to disengage.
Okay. That's a fair way to decide. Oh, you also take 4 ongoing.
Right, yeah.
And you can save that at the end.
Yep. Actually, I'm going to, one second, let me check.
Just don't take a million years and we're good.
Yep, okay. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to do, Spurring Mantis Strike. So I'm going to, roll to disengage as a part of the attack.
Is that a thing?
For this attack it is.
Okay.
So
yeah, you have a plus 5.
I did not disengage.
You have a plus 5 to the attack, but yeah. Plus 2 from...
Yeah, you get plus 2 from me. Yeah.
That was a disengage check, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So you failed.
Which I fail. So I'm going to take the opportunity attack.
Oh, you're going to take another vile... Oh, sorry. Wicked scythe. Different.
And I think I get plus 2 AC because I am tiny or small.
Yes. From
too bad
that
hits.
You can, that scythe, you're really easy on the scythe.
I did the damage for you. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Then
you're
now
at 8 ongoing, so that's gonna fucking suck.
Great. So I'm gonna attack Abhishek.
Yes.
Which is going to be plus 6 plus 5.
Yes.
Because yeah, escalation die plus that, so that's gonna be plus 11.
Mm-hmm. It is going to be exceedingly hard to miss.
Watch this. I'm gonna roll 1.
Close.
I get to re-roll. Does that hit?
Close enough.
No, it does not, but you do get to re-roll 2s. Congratulations.
I do.
Wait, don't forget, yeah, you get a plus 2, right? You already had the plus 2.
I already had that.
Okay.
But, little known fact, when you are dual wielding, and monks are always considered dual wielding, on 2s you get to re-roll your attack.
Uh-huh.
Yep. That is correct.
So, I hit him for 21. Alright, yes. I rolled 21. Okay.
You are probably it is probably impossible to not take him out.
I deal 11 damage.
Oh, heck that. Alright. So,
and now, as
are you
my move action...
Are you killing the guy, or are you leaving him disabled?
Let's do subdual damage.
Okay. Oh, it's up to you. There's no subdual damage thing. It's up to you whether or not you kill him or not. That's
right, yeah, I don't kill him.
Okay.
I'm saying I vaporized the guy.
And then I'm going to use my move action.
Mm-hmm.
To move action back to Thrilla.
Nice!
Re-engage with him.
Perfect.
So I just heard him say, hey, 1 second! jump over, slam my hand into Abhishek's neck, shoulder area, then run back over.
I'm for it.
All right. Now I'm going to jump into engaged, and I'm going to... just hit the guy.
Oh, Al, you forgot to roll your save ends against those.
Oh, that's right.
One of those.
Two of those now?
You have to do two of them now, yeah. Although, it will just end at the end of the fight, so if this takes some...
15 AC?
Yeah, so... Oh,
okay.
So I pass one.
Yes. 15 to hit AC, let's see. I remember... Okay, you did add it.
Yeah.
Ha! Eat it. Yes, 16.
Damn. Well, 2 damage.
I think that's... You've done that every time you tried to do something cool.
I have.
Except for when you attacked Bort.
Yep.
What'd you roll?
Bort's easy on the knives.
Damn it, I wish that was a... If that was a 5, you would have taken damage for that from my vile aura. Well, you know you are going to get hit with. Going to lift up the mask.
You're going to kill Bart.
Well, how much damage?
That's 15 versus your physical defense.
Yes, it is 14.
You're going to fucking kill him.
Not kill, but that is going to be 6 damage. Poison damage. You're down, but you're not dead.
Yeah, I'm down.
You are at minus 1. Mm-hmm. You are now disabled. On your turn, you will roll a death save. It is actually kind of, like, easy to stabilize in this game, so it's not a big deal.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to... Is this far close enough where I can move? Well, I'm gonna move more in the vicinity. Let's see. I could go for a melee attack and see. Well, actually, yeah, because the escalation die is currently at 3, correct?
Yes.
It's at 3.
Oh wait, no, that's triggering on a natural 11. Okay, never mind. I was gonna say I could try actually going for a melee hit to see if I could give you a recovery, but.
Well, you can totally still do that.
Yeah.
Roll over an 11.
I would have to roll 11.
Mm-hmm.
Natural 11. So, or do I want to just try? How much HP does he have left?
He has 18 left.
So the chance of me killing him with a battle chant at this point is pretty low.
Pretty slim, yeah.
What's his MD? His mental defense. Is it pretty high?
Oh, technically speaking, I'm not supposed to tell you this, but I will anyway. It is 16, identical to his age.
Okay, if you didn't, Jeff, you didn't have to tell me if you didn't think it was. You know.
It was okay.
So he's got few HP.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Nah. Okay, so that won't work.
Roll a die and choose.
Sorry. I'm going to go with just a basic melee.
Okay.
I'll get in the grill. I'll get my punch on.
Get a punch that.
22 versus AC.
You did a ton. No.
And also, because I got a natural even hit.
That is actually a natural odd.
Is it?
You rolled a 17.
Oh, sorry. I didn't highlight it. Yes. You're right. Sorry. You're right. I should have looked at that. All right. Never mind.
Just punch him right in the gut.
I punched him.
Not appreciated. He's spewing vile spew everywhere. Oh, Bart is just coated in spew. It's gross.
Well, at least disgusting. It's also in the tide, so... Mm-hmm.
All right, Bort.
Gonna
get grabbed by the ghoulies, isn't he?
Yeah, because I can just sort of do that whenever I want.
Yeah, gonna get grabbed.
So, it's gonna be my...
Yep, that does it.
12.
Yeah, okay, you just kind of... Again, are you killing him or not?
He's a crim.
He is the crim. He is a criminal, yeah.
He is a criminal, huh?
Do you have a concept of criminals?
No. I'm gonna murder him.
Yeah.
Oh, this puts me in an awkward situation.
Yeah, he just tears his parts apart, and they're all gross. He's full of spew. How is there so much spew in one thing?
Yeah, I kind of just pull him to pieces, because it's like, I don't have... That's not a concept I understand, so it's like...
Like a whole bunch of goo just, like, starts to flow into the ocean. You probably just caused an oil spill or something.
Oh boy. Seems unfortunate.
Oh, you beat that encounter. Congratulations.
So does Bart still have to roll against dying at this point?
No, he's fine.
You were allowed, guys.
Between fights, you're basically allowed to do recoveries as you like.
Yep.
So if you, the traditional thing is just to start rolling them now.
I'm gonna spend recoveries.
All right. Well, I'm gonna pull Abishek up.
I don't need to anymore.
And I don't know.
You're welcome.
Yes.
Pull him off the rock.
That worked very, very well.
I'm gonna go ahead and pull him over to the shore.
Disrespect was unwelcome.
And I don't know, like...
Drown the sucker!
I can't really turn him in now, because he was
give me a second. Criminal. I need to go get a cat.
As you do.
I mean, you could take him in, as he did attack people for no reason. That's a crime.
I mean... But we could have attacked him first.
To be fair, we're outside city limits. No laws out here.
I'm just gonna, like, make sure he's, like, not bleeding to death and then leave him laying on the beach.
Can I... Okay, then I'm gonna use his blood and draw right around this guy's a fucker. You know, just okay. So people know. And so he also knows when he wakes up. If when he wakes up, he'll know for a fact he was, in fact, a fucker. And all his friends are dead. Those guys he met like 12 minutes, like a day ago.
I'd say more cohorts than friends.
Yeah, his cohorts that he met a day ago are dead.
All right, I'm back. I acquired the cat.
Cool.
What's up?
So Al is just leaving this guy by the shore because he's not sure if he can actually take him in.
Yeah, you did kind of just kill the rest of his squad, who were more or less just doing this thing.
Well, they were fuckers.
One guy that was a criminal.
One dude who was, like, really gross, but otherwise not a bad guy. No, wait, no, they were both the same guy. Shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Abishek is not a criminal, though.
We had the flame guy who got punched in half by the big guy, but then I killed the big guy because he punched that guy in half, but also because I just wanted to.
Which is why I'm just stabilizing him, then leaving him on the beach.
Okay, fair enough.
Murdered a dude because his friends attacked me.
That guy was a criminal, so it's fine.
I don't know what... I don't have a concept of that.
Technically, Abishek has done nothing wrong. He didn't murder a dude, he didn't commit crimes, so...
Well, I mean, he totally picked a fight with us, and that was doing it wrong.
Well, he's not dead.
Oh, well, good for him.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay, there you go. See, we are merciful.
You know, one out of four ain't bad.
Yeah, whatever.
All right, so we came here to look for the evidence stuff. Anybody see any manners? Not that I believe in them.
There is no manner here.
Is there anything...
We have all three sections of the map, right?
Yes. Well, you have a book, a painting, a canvas, and a tablet.
I'm going to go through their stuff and see if I can find any of their maps.
Sure. Yeah.
Which was the guy who had it?
It was going to be... What did I note wrote down as the leader here?
Was it the big guy?
Nah, the big guy wasn't the fucking leader. He was just muscle.
Okay, can I say I totally vaporized that guy?
That was Master Thrilla, apparently. Poison Man.
The guy we tore, that Bort tore in half.
Yep.
Disrespect is unwelcome.
It's really strange because he has like a ball that has writing on it. Like if you just root through his stuff, he has like a ball. Like, and when I say ball, I mean like a basketball. Huh. A fucking basketball with writing on it. It's made of rubber and everything.
Hmm.
I perform the chaos dunk.
No.
No.
Well, great. Now we have to roll, you know, d20 against existence.
You do 278 damage to everyone in the vicinity.
Oh no!
Well, game over, guys.
I win. I'm the richest.
Bort finally understood what a manor was.
So, yeah, they had, like, a basketball with writing on it. They also had a tablet, but it was in Braille. And, just kind of, like, a pamphlet that was written by, like, it's an election pamphlet.
So you've decided to become evil.
Pretty much. So you've decided to look for my house. Instructions inside.
Okay, so if we... Are the maps inside kind of redundant with ours?
More or less, they pretty much lead to the same thing, but they do mention a cove, which yours may have, but it was kind of obscured in all of the teen poetry.
Okay. So let's, look, right, for, so let's look for
let's
a cove.
Let's find the cove.
Everybody's about as recovered as they want to be.
I bet Bar could use another one.
I mean, I'm basically almost like a little below X.
The important thing is you cannot just spend these in the middle of a fight.
Yep.
So you're better off typically to just make yourself, you know, top yourself off.
Sure. And let's see, let me look at my actual thingamajig.
That's good enough for you? Okay.
I can force people to spend recoveries, so that's...
I don't know what the rest of that thing does. Regeneration. Okay.
Let's see, where is my...
It actually makes sense once I read it. Basically, when I cast it, you roll your recovery and get half. The next turn, for free, you roll your recovery and get half. Then you save. If you succeed on the save, you continue to gain half free recoveries until you fail a save.
Okay.
Which is actually really good.
That is... Wow.
Yeah, regeneration is actually really good. And it continues after combat ends. It specifically says that. You continue to roll saves to see how many you get extra until it fails out. No. They specifically call that out. They're like, yeah, you might get 150 or 200% healing out of the single recovery. Go for it.
Nice.
Yeah. Regeneration's actually really, really good. Regeneration becomes a hard save 16 if you die while it's on you. But you know. Yeah. But yeah, no, I remember reading that the first time and being like, no, that's pretty cool, because I remember looking up how recoveries work, and I was like, yeah, that's... Regeneration can be really strong.
Right, right.
Or you can just botch it and just get your one recovery, but hey, at least I still force you to be able to use a recovery in combat.
Right.
And I can use it as a quick action on myself.
Sweet.
Or a nearby ally with an interrupt action, which I'm not quite sure what that is.
An interrupt just basically means it doesn't take an action, it just happens.
Oh, okay, cool.
It's like flipping up a morph.
State-based action.
Can I do that at any point, or do I have to wait for my turn?
Interrupts usually have a trigger, but if it just happens whenever you want, including on other people's turns.
Yeah, no, that's cool. Yeah, it's close quarters, interrupt action, or quick action, depending on whether it's them or me. So yeah, regeneration's really good.
You recommend it?
I recommend it.
Regenerating, pretty all right.
I also recommend getting stabbed by a frog, because that actually turned out real good.
Yeah.
To be fair, it's why I frog-fisted you.
To be fair, I roll d10s for my recovery, so normal people would not go out as well as I did.
Yeah. All right, so let's look for this cove.
Yeah, go look for the cove.
I'm a tunnel scout.
Did I find
a cove? Oh, you are a tunnel scout. You can totally scout those tunnels. Holy shit.
Is that relevant here?
Yeah.
Sure.
What is a cove but a water tunnel?
Pretty much.
Yeah, okay.
What's the stat going to be? Wisdom?
Up to you, probably.
Well, that's my high stat, so. 24.
Did you find the fuck out of that cove,
you're
probably.
You're going to find that.
Just step into the water, put my arms out, cove's over there.
Pretty good. Good call. You found it. You found
the
cove.
We're inside. We're in my domain.
Everywhere. No. Your domain is in the ground.
I'm a druid. I've got both ground and nature as my domains.
Huh. All right.
I dual classed into the surface and the ground.
I've got ground.
Civilization.
I got ground. I got nature. I got the dirt domain. I got the mud. I got all of them.
I can talk to plants. I can talk to animals.
I can talk to fungi.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, it's relatively hidden. It's got a cove in there, though. It leads out into a shore line underneath the thinger. Not a shoreline, but it's kind of like an underground. It's what do you even call this? It's like it is a cove underground. It's an opening into the ocean.
A cave?
But it's a cave, yes. It's an ocean cave.
Sure.
And in the ocean cave, there is a house.
It's
a very large, pretty nice-looking manor that's, like, it's just out of range so it doesn't get hit by all the sea spray all the time. Though if you were going to touch the side of it, it is coated in salt.
Ugh. So, Bort, you wanted to know what a manor is? That's a manor.
I don't want to touch it.
I don't believe in that. I believe in selling that.
You can roll to disbelieve if you want.
All right, okay, let's do this here. Let's roll intelligence against this. Let's see.
It looks like this, but underneath a cave roof, pretty much.
I have a house in EQ2 that looks like that, really.
Let's see.
Castle inside of a cave.
So what should I roll here? I should roll 1d20 plus.
You can totally use frog to disbelieve, I guess.
No, well, plus 5 plus... it'd be plus 5, minus 1, because it's clearly intelligence.
Yes.
So minus 1.
Plus 2.
Plus 2. I continuously disbelieve this. I definitely do not believe in this.
You kind of trick yourself into thinking that isn't there. It's not there. It's not a thing. Even when you go inside of it, eventually, it's just, nope. This isn't a thing. Not here.
It's like, I mean, I believe in housing in general. It's just that I don't believe explicitly in manners as a concept.
Yeah, because it's just fucking... It's the elite lording over all of the lower class, man.
I'm a simple country frog, simple bog frog. I don't know about these sort of things. Manners, psh.
Alright, well, Geros is, flipping out, saying he doesn't believe in it. I'm gonna go knock on the front door.
Okay. You knocked on the front door. Knock, knock, knock. Knock. Knock, knock, knock.
The owner's knock, dead.
Knock. Well...
You could butlers.
A butler?
So, like,
Think about, like, what Lil Bort is to you, but, like, a full-size person.
That's fucked up.
Also, not it's
pretty accurate. Mind. That's pretty accurate, though. I don't believe in, you know, manners, but I believe in that. I believe in that.
Butlers? You believe in butling?
I believe in butling. I believe in little butlers.
I believe in a little thing called butlum.
Little butlers.
I guess the house is ours now?
I mean, they are. I try the knob.
It opens.
Hooray.
It, looks like this.
Okay.
Little tiny bit run down, not entirely. Looks pretty good, really.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Holding up surprisingly well, despite being in a sea cave.
Yep. Pretty nice.
Should I be rolling? Should I be rolling perception at this point? Do I see anything out of like myth, like that I should be worried about? Like,
what are you looking at? You don't believe anything here exists.
Good point. Well, that makes me highly skeptical of anything supposedly inside.
It's pretty true.
So I'm just gonna roll a d20 to see if I perceive anything that looks amiss, even you know, if this was real.
Welcome to the spooky first person view.
Oh, I roll six.
I need to make another map. I just realized. Give me a second.
I don't see anything here that looks amiss, apparently.
No, you don't. Not at all.
Like, if I believed in manners, which I don't, this looks like a pretty normal one. I choose to kick a table.
Mm-hmm. You kick the table.
Okay. As a rogue, I'm really good at finding traps. Are there traps?
It's a manor. Why would there be traps?
You know, crazy man.
This is a manor that was owned by a minotaur.
Yeah, but that just means it has a weird, like, layout where it's, like, always leading into the center of it. You know, because it's made by, like, a labyrinth.
Look, I'm a wizard. I'm a little bit racist. I'm going to assume he put traps in here.
He's okay. Got a point. He's got a point.
Look, I'm a wizard. I'm a little bit racist.
I'm a little bit rock and roll.
This music is no longer fitting, by the way. You need to replace it with like a spooky, like, haunted house movie. Like some Scooby-Doo-ass music. Boom, boom, boom.
Perfect.
Sure.
So, 20 to find traps?
There are no traps. I was kind of leading into this. This is not a trap room, because it is a place that someone lives in.
Alright then.
You
I've
fucking
established
awful wizard, baby.
I've established that we are in no danger of dying at this moment.
Well, yeah, we're in a house.
In a cave.
Yeah. Kind of secure, actually.
Next to the ocean.
Mm-hmm. These are all true facts we're saying.
Wait a minute. Wasn't there another group?
Yeah, but they were lazy.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, are we going to have to defend this house against them? This manor that I don't believe in?
Nah. We don't all don't believe in, just you don't believe
that,
in.
I said that I don't believe in.
Oh, okay. I thought you said that we all don't believe in. And it's like,
Well, I'm gonna go find the kitchen. I'm hungry.
Give me a second.
He's pulling up a map. Give him a minute.
I'm making a map right now. So instead, you guys can explore the labyrinth, the house, the manor. It's called Labyrinth Manor. It's not actually very labyrinthine. Parts of it hold up worse than others. Apparently he didn't actually live in most of it.
So I'm guessing he did not have anybody to buttle for him.
Nope.
Okay, so it's one old man in a manor. In a sea cave.
Okay. To be fair, the old man was a minotaur.
And apparently a bit weird. He liked, you know, teenage poetry.
Yeah. He's a fucking weirdo.
I believe that spider outright said he was a weirdo.
Yes, that happened.
A giant spider, you know, businessman said that. I'm inclined to believe him.
He did, in fact, tell me that the old man was a weirdo.
I'm inclined to believe every giant spider businessman.
So we're also told there is a treasure in this building.
Oh, yeah.
So is it out in plain sight right now, or do you need to dig around for it?
You're going to have to dig around for it a bit.
Okay.
Do you want us to take five while you're making this map, or...?
No, just like us things amongst yourself, because I'm almost done.
Okay.
Let's split up, gang.
Zoid, Scoob!
Come on, did I upload this? I had to have uploaded this. This is very important. You're going to find a very, very important picture frame. On, where did I put it? I didn't not make it.
Oh,
there it is. All right, you're gonna find in a bedroom. A very important portrait of a guy you might know and love or hate.
Okay.
Bat Boy lives!
Yep, just hanging above the bed.
You took your entire time doing this.
No, no. I did not.
Oh my gosh.
You also... All of a sudden... The Bat Boy portrait. It goes flying at you!
Woo!
Wow! Woo! But no, actually, like, it tries to slam into your throat or something. Into...
Oh, God.
The tallest person, which is Bart's throat.
Oh, great.
Yeah, like, goes flying into your face.
Is that a trap, or do we need to roll initiative against portrait?
No, it was neither.
I'm going to duck.
Okay.
There's a spirit in this room. I can't talk to spirits.
You succeed in ducking. Congratulations on succeeding in the ducking.
Thank you. I'd rather not get hit by a portrait.
And you're probably right. There is, in fact, probably a spirit in this room.
Well,
you've got experience here, Al.
Well,
I do.
Well,
and 16. Oh, spirits, you know the drill.
Get the fuck out of my house.
This is our house now.
You can suck a basket.
Sir, we're trying to be cordial.
I will fuck you up.
Sir.
Get out of my house.
Hello, sir or madam. Are you the ghost?
Shitty frog.
Wow, rude.
Get off your feet.
Are these your feet? Throw the feet on the ground. Did this house belong to these feet?
Yes.
Then it's not your house?
It is definitely my house.
But those aren't your feet?
Are you George?
Yeah, are you George? Did you know George?
I knew George.
Well, that's nice, but in his will reading, we were kind of given the house, so...
Fuck the rules!
I don't believe in matters, but I believe in contracts involving me getting stuff.
I believe in you getting your ass kicked.
Can you actually hurt us outside of throwing things at us? Really?
I double dog dare you to manifest yourself so I can hit you with lightning. Come on.
Oh, you piece of shit, you're on.
I'm gonna roll charisma to see if he's just outright gonna do that. Okay.
Oh yeah.
I was gonna say, like, otherwise, I will totally roll charisma to do this.
You know, strangely, this is not the weirdest spirit eviction I've ever had to do.
Is that a common thing for you social workers?
Not as common, but it happens now and again.
We don't really, I mean, we get a lot of ghosts in the bog, but it's usually bog spirits, you know, St. Olmo's fires, that sorts of thing. They're pretty cool.
We had to kick a succubus out of the caves once, but we mostly just asked her to go do her thing someplace else. The bodies were starting to pile up. It seemed nice.
Well, that's how succubus do.
I borrowed a book from a spirit once. Never gave it back to him. He didn't ask.
You can see that, right?
Yeah, we can see it. The token. Yes. Yeah. We can't see ourselves though.
Yeah, I know, because you're in first person mode right now.
Well, are we gonna battle this thing or what?
Well, then follow me, you piece of shit.
Yeah. Is he dimension warping or like going through a door?
I think he's just turning sideways.
He's going into the crypt.
Okay.
There's a crypt in this matter.
Oh.
I'll totally fight a thing in a crypt. Why not?
Of course there is. Hey.
I should have paced this out better. This is just two fights right after each other.
Does it have to be? I mean, you can live in the crypt.
Let's take the terrible route here. Hello, spirit. Hello, I am Frog.
Hello, Frog. I'm a fucking rad spirit.
Okay, you know, I agree. Spirits are pretty rad. Do you want to know what's also kind of rad? Frogs. Have you ever considered being the spirit of a frog? There is much to be learned and much to be enlightened about frogs. Let me tell you what here. Frogs are pretty great. Frogs are the truth of the reality of all things. If you became a frog, you would find yourself a much peaceful, happy spirit. You can move to the great frog beyond. The great pond in the sky. I'm gonna convert this fucking ghost to frog.
Oh, roll another 20.
Alright, so roll 1d20 plus 5 plus 5 plus 2.
Not even the closest little lick of sense is being made here.
I've got a question.
What's that? I'm destroying my throat.
I don't think any of us actually want the house. We just want the treasure. Do you know where that is?
Back here.
Can we just have the treasure and leave?
Maybe.
Because, like, I don't think any of us want the house. It's kind of not our thing.
I strictly don't believe in it.
He doesn't believe in it, and I don't need a house, and I think the other two just want to go home.
Oh, yeah.
I'm kind of a day behind on work.
Then let's...
I don't even remember why I came to Drakkenhall in the first place.
Then let's play my favorite game.
Okay.
Blackjack.
Spider Solitaire?
Blackjack. Yeah, right. Let's play the deck. Load the deck. Play some cards.
I'll wager my soul.
I mean, it's not like I want to run away from a fight. I just see no reason to fight the spirit, because...
I'll wager the frog soul.
Hey, now.
I don't even remember how to spawn the deck.
I think Tears figured it out earlier.
I've spawned the deck.
All right, but all draw, hit draw a card. You put your thing over it. You just hit draw. Draw two cards.
Hold up. I can deal one to all players.
Oh, well, we're already drawing cards.
Okay, do it.
Okay.
I will stay.
I'm gonna hit.
Okay, well, let's do this.
Should I just draw myself one card?
I will give it to you.
Okay.
Should we be going through
the final boss track?
Well, I busted.
Ha! Eat it. How about you, Frog?
I will also draw.
Alright, get ready to get destroyed.
I got 22.
Alright, so I probably should actually go around this in a rotation, actually. As you
Yeah. Then
I believe. I believe the statement was fuck the rules.
Radway, also known as Bart, what's your turn?
Give me a card.
Alright, get ready to get schooled. How are you feeling now?
Let's see. I'm feeling lucky. Give me another card.
Are you trying to steal from me?
I was accidentally.
Ghost trying to steal. Ghost trying to steal a card from me.
Just trying to get a hand.
All right, so now it's Kabanaw. It's up.
I don't know what to do with this card. It's the Joker.
Oh. Wow.
Pretend it doesn't exist and move on to another card.
All right, fine.
Because technically you're supposed to remove the Joker from a blackjack deck.
Yeah. So, Kabanaw, are you going to draw? Do you need to draw a card?
I'll hit.
All right, let's go. How you doing?
Stay.
All right.
I'd still like another card, please.
What card? What the fuck's wrong with you?
Fuck. All right, I busted.
Gee, you think you have like 14 cards?
Look, she kept giving me aces.
That would have been a good poker hand, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Would have.
All right, I would like another card. Give me a card.
Oh, fuck. Damn it. All right, fine. Go on.
Give me.
I can't put my cards down. There we go.
There.
I will stay.
All right. Show your shit. Fifteen. Check me out. I'm the best.
20.
17.
Fuck you!
Eat a dick, ghost. Strictly speaking, I don't have those, by the way.
But, okay, fine, whatever. Well, we played a blackjack and you won. Congratulations, you own the treasure.
Sweet.
I don't want
it. Thank you.
Now get the fuck out of my house.
Yeah, that's fine.
Sure.
Bye.
By the way, some huge nerds may be showing up later to try to steal your shit. You should totally murder them. Not us, though.
All right, got it.
You want us to, like, hire somebody to make this place not look run down or something, or are you just cool with that?
Nah, I'm fine with it.
Okay.
I'll make sure to spread ghost stories about you.
Okay.
Okay, so where's this treasure? What does this treasure look like?
It is a whole bunch of generic ass...
Who's your father, and what does he do?
It's a whole bunch of generic ass treasure because all of his interesting stuff was, taken by the government, pretty much.
Okay.
And I can work out, like, magic item shits another time.
Sure. Why not?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We should punch the ghost.
You'll fight the ghost next time anyway. If there is a next time. I don't know if there is.
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah.
I didn't want to make it run forever.
Yep, that's fair. I thought this was pretty fun. Thank you for doing this, Dicktron.
No problem.
I had a good time.
I like how 13th Age flows.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it flows pretty well. I didn't even do a montage when I probably should have. Montages are great.
Yep,
I don't even know what that means.
It's just a narrative thing that like got introduced in this game, and it's pretty fun.
Mm-hmm. I've actually been using it in other systems.
Mm-hmm. Basically, you just have every player make up something that happens in a journey.
And another player makes up the answer to that problem, too.
Interesting. Yeah, this was fun. We should do this again sometime.
Yes.
If Red actually ends up showing up for one, I would really look forward to Red and then Zorak doing one of the montages, because that would be hilarious.
I will talk to Red about forcing him down to do this.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That was good.
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 I had fun.
I am no longer in control of everyone's fate.
All right.
Get the fuck out of here. Get out. Get out of this thing. Get out now. Get out of it.
What should I do with these hooves, by the way?
I'm
going to add them to my inventory, actually.
They will become your magic item.
I'm going to add hooves to my inventory. I also added the 3 gold I got from earlier.
Good. Just so you know, I never keep money, but okay.
I'm adding it anyways for personal gratification.
All right.